This is done by inviting people from industries and top institutions to provide valuable information to our students. Before I begin, I would like to take the privilege to tell you all about our dais. Keeping in view the growing need of educational opportunities for children with the exposure to contemporary circumstances and to develop them into responsible citizens as a national resource, Shri K.C. Garg and his wife, Mrs. Anita Garg, established the society, namely Seth Pokarmal Educational Society, SPMES, to serve the society as a whole. Under the aegis of SPMES, they started Rukmani Devi Public School in Pitampura and perpetuated the name of his revered father, Seth Pokarmal, and his respected mother, Srimati Rukmani Devi, who were having their vision for education of masses in India. Seth Pokarmal Educational Society, established in 1986, operates several institutes of repute under the brand name of Rukmani Devi. Through its concerted efforts, the society has created institutions of international standard that impart quality education right from the kindergarten stage to doctoral level programs at very affordable prices. At present, the society has the following institutions under its umbrella: Rukmani Devi Public School in Pitampura, Rukmani Devi Institute of Advanced Studies in Rohini, Rukmani Devi Lalit Kala Kendra in Pitampura, Rukmani Devi Public School in Rohini, Rukmani Devi Public School Junior Wing in Pitampura, Rukmani Devi College of Education in Rohini, Rukmani Devi Public School in Sonipat, Rukmani Devi Center of Excellence in Computational Nanotechnology. Let me now introduce you all to the guest speaker of the day, Mr. Ranjan Malik, who is an innovation facilitator, methodology creator, and speaker. He created the methodology for Innovation for India Awards, Forbes Global Innovation Awards, and 3C Spot Fund Nurture Model used by NABARD in the area of rural innovation. A person with a refreshingly different take on life and work, he has led and facilitated innovation in number of organizations in various countries. He has also created methodologies, frameworks and tools that help organizations innovate by design, like the innovation evaluation architecture used in Innovation Awards, Innovation for India Awards, Tata Innovation Awards, Forbes Wipro Global Awards, and NABARD, 3C's Spot Fund Nurture Model for Rural Innovation. Sir is a dynamic and charismatic speaker. He is sought for his unique ability to pick unobvious insights, connect unusual dots, and present a very compelling message in his spontaneous style. He has been on the jury for India Design Council, India Design Mark, National Skill Development Corporation of India, Tata Innovation Awards, and Mahindra Innovation Awards. He delivers keynotes and methodology sessions on orbit shifting innovation and storm the norm. He has been mapping mental model boundaries for various industries using a metacognitive methodology that he has developed over the last 14 years. He has led and facilitated innovation initiatives in a large number of organizations across the world, including Apple, GlaxoSmithKline, Honeywell, J&J, Microsoft, Mahindra Auto, Max New York Insurance, Nestle, PepsiCo, Perfetti, Tata Group, Unilever, and Whirlpool. He has also been a speaker and chaired sessions for various conferences like Front End of Innovation Amsterdam, Strategic Innovation Forum in Barcelona, the India Innovation Summit in Bangalore, Innovation for India Awards in Mumbai, National Brand Summit IMA, TEDx, Asia HRD Congress, to name a few. He has also interactive talks at Indian Institute of Management in Bangalore, Kolkata, and Indore. Also IIT Mumbai, Center for Leadership Innovation and Change in ISB, and National Institute of Design in Ahmedabad. Mr. Ranjan spent a decade in advertising and marketing with organizations like J. Walter Thompson, Lintas and Bharti. Now I would request Dr. Tripti Tur, Chairperson for Center for Idea, Innovation, Incubation and Entrepreneurship, to please facilitate Mr. Ranjan. In today's time, business and innovation are two inseparable terms. With a fast-paced technology-oriented world, where we constantly need to be updated not only with the latest trends, but challenge our existing ideas, formulate something new. So this session will be an all-round learning experience for all of us here, where our existing notions about a successful business will find a new dimension, and our thought process would be widened too. Innovation facilitator training is perfect for directors, consultants, managers, and other organization leaders individually or within their innovation leadership team. This is an in-depth program designed for leaders who step forward to bring more innovation and collaboration to the organization as a whole. This innovation facilitator training program is built for businesses interested in helping customers, teams and individuals in your organization to use an innovation process for developing new products or services or improving processes, doing more with less and making new things happen. As students who aspire to be future leaders for tomorrow, this session would indeed prove out to be a turning point for us. So without any further ado, I would request Mr. Ranjan to kindly open the forum for discussion.
Hello, hello. Right. I'm happy to be here, and it's thanks to Tripti. We were together in the university, and when she reached out and she says that she would like to invite me here to speak to the students, I was really happy, because we're meeting after 27 years, almost 30. So we studied together, we did our management together. So we're going to talk about innovation. Innovation is something that I've, you know, all of us are innovators. I mean, it's nothing, it's not that someone who learns to be goes and does a course in innovation facilitation becomes an innovation facilitator. I think all of us are innovators. That's the route I took to learning about innovation. I learned by doing. I never went for a course in innovation. There were none, in fact, when I became this was 16 years ago when I decided to be an innovation facilitator. It wasn't even something that people knew existed. In fact, after many years of doing this, when I deliver lectures or I conduct my sessions across the world, people come to me and ask me, how do you become an innovation facilitator? I just say, you just become. No, is there a course we can do to become become an innovation facilitator? So I tell them, no, so you shouldn't do it. Because you're looking for a course, then you shouldn't be, because innovation is a field that makes sense of the fuzzy front end. And if you are a person who wants to look for existing knowledge first, to be able to create new knowledge, then maybe you're not the person. And as I was sharing with Tripti and some of your faculty members earlier, that I didn't do well in school. In fact, I was a pretty average student. I wasn't a good student, in fact. That's what the school told me through the report cards, and I believed the report cards because I didn't know any better, you know. You are tentative, you're growing up, whatever the world tells you, you kind of believe. So I started to believe I was pretty average. Then something very interesting happened. This was in class 11th or 12th. I think class 12th. I think the world's made a big deal out of 10th and 12th and board, and it's not just the students, but the whole family is going through stress. That's the kind of world we live in today, and that's strange. I think, why should anyone go through stress? Why should we feel, somewhere we also feel that, you know, we want to make our kids competitive, that children or students should be competitive because they have to compete. I actually believe that all competition is rooted in insecurity. If you are feeling competitive, you are insecure. Because if you are secure, you wouldn't want to beat anyone else. Because the logic is that you have to beat many people to be able to succeed in the world. Why beat? You have to beat because when you pick up a field that already has not thousands but lakhs of people around the world learning the same thing, and there are thousands who've actually written books about it, and so obviously you'll want to compete, because otherwise what is the uniqueness that you will come up with? But if you have created your own field, then where's the competition? Then you're the only one in the world who's doing it, right? So you don't need to compete really, so you're pretty secure. But that's something I realized only later. So this happened in class 12, that I was telling you, I was drifting through school. I didn't know what was happening. I hated coming every day to school. I didn't like my teachers. I liked a few subjects. I didn't know why I liked them, because I just liked them, you know. I was standing in front of the school principal's room somehow, feeling pretty lost, because the assembly was ready to begin, when this classmate of mine came running to me. He was also a house captain. So he came running to me and saying, Ranjan, we have a problem on our hands. I said, what happened? So I was in a Kendriya Vidyalaya. And we used to have these houses. You know how we have houses in school. So he says, he was the house captain. He says, it was our responsibility to run the assembly and to put that thought for the day on the board. And that day's cartoon, you know, anyone who could draw well in the house would come and draw the cartoon. So he says, the guy who draws hasn't come today, so you'll have to draw. I said, and before I could tell him I can't draw, he'd run away. He'd given me the day's cartoon. I still remember it was Sudhidhar cartoon. Some days it would be R.K. Lakshman, some days Sudhidhar. That day it was Sudhidhar. Someone had brought the clipping. He says, this is the clipping, here are some chalks, here's the duster, that's the board, draw. And I'm standing there saying, okay. And then he says, no, I have to get to the assembly to read the news, so I can't wait. And then while running, he says, there's no marks for drawing, just any squiggles. We don't want to lose points. Anything, just anything. I said, okay. So I started to draw. And there was a countdown on, because the assembly was on, I could hear. Because it had to be over before the assembly ended. So I was just drawing, and after I finished, and I finished pretty fast, I was surprised. I think I surprised myself that day. I saw the cartoon, I said, wow, that's amazing. I said, I'm a cartoonist. You know, imagine a person who didn't know what to do in life. Everyone is telling you, you're average, you're not good enough, you need to work hard, what will you do in life? You get nowhere. Had just drawn a cartoon and he likes it and he says, yeah, I'm a cartoonist too. And that day, I remember, it was an amazing day for me, because everyone came and complimented me, great, 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 great. I said, okay, great. For the first time, I'd received so many compliments. I went home and I told my parents what happened, my siblings too. And I said, I want to be a cartoonist. You know, I discovered something that I liked. So my mother and my father said, okay, so finish school, then go to an art college, and then become a cartoonist. I said, that is like 7-8 years, but I want to be a cartoonist now, because I'm already a cartoonist. They said, no, but you have to finish the studies. I said, okay. I went to one of my favorite teachers, who I thought was much better than the other ones. So she said the same thing. Go to an art college, JJ School of Art, some Jamia Millia, something, some words they gave me. And I said, no. And I was in JNK that time. They said, you have to go to Delhi or Bombay and join one of those colleges. I said, that's a 5-year plan, 7-year plan. But I said, these adults are not telling me great things. So on a Saturday, Sunday, I remember, I didn't tell anyone. boards were approaching, but I, on a Saturday, I think it was, I just stepped out of my home, went to two or three local newspapers there in JNK, and I would go to these, you know, newspaper offices at the reception. I would say, I want to meet the editor. He says, okay, but why? I'm a cartoonist, I want to draw for you. And I used to look younger than my age, you know, and they would be amused, what's this little kid doing, cartoonist and all that. So anyway, but I would go with a lot of confidence, I'm a cartoonist, I want to draw. I said, okay, so they would let me meet the editor, the chief editor. So I met a few, and they would ask me, so, you know, we need political cartoons, and by when can you show us the samples? And I would tell them, day after tomorrow. I had no idea what I was going to draw. I'd only drawn one cartoon in my life. And I thought I was a cartoonist. So anyway, so one of them said, okay, bring it to us day after tomorrow and we'll take it from there. And I know how I spent those 2 days. I just couldn't get myself to draw. There used to be these political leaders that time, Farooq Abdullah and G.M. Shah and etc. and JNK, local politics. I just couldn't get the faces right. I'd drawn that cartoon, I'd copied it. But I couldn't draw. But anyway, but I was bad. I mean, I threw so many, but finally I managed to draw a couple. And I went and showed it to the editor. And exactly 2 months from then, I started to draw for that newspaper. So I drew for that newspaper, I became a cartoonist. I used to have a box on the front page. Started to come, joined a college. I started studying geology. Because I didn't like any other, by elimination and then by selection. I don't like the subject. That leaves geology. Okay, I like it. So I picked it up. And my college principal would, every time there would be a VIP into the college, they would call me. I would be called to the principal's office. Do you see the cartoons in the newspaper every day? Yeah, that's our student. I say, wow, okay. So that's the story. So I realized something very interesting that time. That the world will tell you, show you a route, that this is how you need to get there. Don't believe them. Because I had cracked a principle that I followed after that in all my life, which I called the 11-month principle. And I said, anything in the world can be done in 11 months. Why 11? I don't know. Because maybe the cartoons I'd started to truly draw in 11 months, but I realized 11 was almost a year. So that gives you a lot of months, but it was less than a year. So that creates enough pressure. So it was like that. So I'd cracked the cartoon code. And how did I crack it? I realized I wasn't good in drawing. You know, some people are very talented. They can draw well. I couldn't. So I said, cartooning needs two things. One, drawing skills and one, thinking skills. I have the thinking skills. That's what I believed. Drawing skills I don't have. But why do I want to be like R.K. Lakshman? If I try very hard to be like R.K. Lakshman, I'll be a poor copy of R.K. Lakshman. I will choose a visual idiom which is so simple that I should be able to draw. So I chose a simple way, almost stick drawing because that I could draw. I said, this is my visual style, and this is my thinking style, I'll bring it together. And that'll be me, that'll not be R.K. Lakshman. And tomorrow, when they all love my cartoons, R.K. Lakshman and Sudhidhar, if they try and be like me, they'll be poor copies of me. It's something that I was telling myself, you know, as a little kid. And I realized how I did it. Then I went on to, you know, win the inter-college and then inter-university and then, you know, went to youth festivals and stuff like that with my cartooning skills. I started to draw for Indian Express and then, but I left that. That was one career I just left behind. But there I realized this is what I was doing. I said, if I can't draw, clip art has come now. I'm talking about 40 years ago, right? I created my own clip art. I said, the world is made of three kinds of things. There are people, there are objects, and there are places. People are men, women, and children. Objects are television, scooters, cars, various objects, tables, chairs. And there are places, there are homes, offices, and markets, or outdoor locations. And I learned one of each kind, one kind of a woman, one kind of a man, and I practiced and practiced and practiced and practiced so many times that I could draw them with my eyes shut. That became my repertoire, my clip art. If you look back at my cartoons, all of them have the same woman, have the same man. It's like copy-paste. That's what I was doing. I'd cracked the code because I was saying I couldn't draw, so I need to crack the code. So somewhere, so that was my first thing. Then I picked up electronics. I started to love electronics. That you could actually put these little pieces of things together and it could become a transistor. It could become a transmitter. So I then created a transmitter circuit which got published. And then I left that behind. I didn't want to be an engineer. While I was in school, all this was happening. I'd cracked the code for electronics. Then I joined advertising. And before I joined advertising, we started to publish a newspaper while doing my MBA. No, before MBA, we started to publish a newspaper for students. And to run that, we needed ads. So I used to create the ads. So I decided to join an ad agency, which I did. So I joined HTA, which is now called JWT. And then I joined Lintas. You know, so those kinds. But I realized that anything can be cracked within months. Now, that's what I followed in my innovation field. Now, I've worked with a large number of companies in India, in Europe, and in US. Whenever we get a project, I'm new. I've done a project in oral care. I've done a project in laundry. With Unilever in London, I've done a laundry project, a personal care project, a healthcare project. With Johnson & Johnson in New Jersey, I've done a project with oral care. I've done projects in automobiles. In water purifiers, air purifiers, I mean, lots of different industries. I don't know these fields. To tell you the truth, when I started the project with Johnson & Johnson in New Jersey, they had the best team in the world. They had double PhDs in oral care sitting in the US, and they had access to the best institutes there. But I realized that people, you know, I don't know if you've heard of the term echo chamber. Echo chamber is a new term that everyone's using these days. It's like saying that you find your own world, and within that world, you hear what you want to hear. It's like you keep getting echo of the same thing. Even algorithms, Google and Facebook, these intelligent bots learn about you and serve you only the content that you would like. They will not serve you anything new, right? So each one of us are living in echo chambers. Industries are also like that. They are like echo chambers. If I'm in oral care, I've been in oral care all my life. Can you hear me? I'm not sure if I can be heard, so I keep adjusting. At the back, so I don't need to scream, because I'm losing my voice, so I'll just kind of speak a little. And we started to work. So the way we follow, so I've designed an innovation process that just does what I had started to do from my school time. Decode a new thing. See it like the existing people haven't seen it. So what we do in the innovation process is, we follow a methodology that I've designed called deconstruct to reconstruct. You take an ecosystem that needs disruption. You take it apart like you take apart a Lego blocks model. Imagine if you had got a hand-me-down Lego block set from your elder brother, who was a great artist, who had made a great artifact, you wouldn't want to change it. You'll say, "Arey yaar, ye kharab ho jayega, itna acha bana hua hai." The best you'll do is add maybe a window here or put a car there or something else, but you won't touch it. It's just so good. You can't, you know, or you maybe you're scared of the elder brother. He'll come and slap you. "Arey, tune itna acha bigad diya." Industries may be aisa hota hai. When we join an industry that's mature, that's had generations of executives who've come and gone, it's a ready artifact. There's an establishment which is almost, and it's so daunting, it's so overwhelming, and it's so polished. You sometimes wonder, what can you do in this new industry? Imagine for a person, when I do, say, oral care, when I get there, I don't know ABC of oral care. And I've been hired, imagine, I've been hired to, in 5 months, come up with a solution that will disrupt oral care industry across the world. It's daunting, right? And I don't know. And the people I'm meeting are experts in oral care. How do you see that? Now, the way we do it is, the thing is, you get answers to questions you ask. Often what happens is, in an industry where incumbents have been there for too long, they keep asking the same old questions. So they keep getting the same old answers. They're not asking new questions. When you ask new questions, you get new answers. So I remember, I started my work on oral care, and I realized, say for example, now I'll show you how you start to think anew. Now this is a ready artifact we've got. Now how do you take it apart? First, and understand what are the current mental models of thinking and how can we make a shift there. If you look at the first engineered toothbrush that was ever made in the world came a couple of centuries ago from China. It was camel bone and pig hair on it. That toothbrush and today's toothbrush are uncannily similar. Not just in form factor, but also the thinking behind it. What's the thinking behind toothbrush? That you can mechanically remove the debris or the food particles from your mouth mechanically and chemically try and control this biological ecosystem, right? So mechanical, which is physical and chemical routes to manipulating a biological system, which is your mouth or the alimentary canal. Now we started to map what theoretically, how many ways can we control a biological system, right? So there is physical, there is chemical, and we realize there are five ways you can control the biological system. Physical, chemical being two, biological being third. Say you take Yakult, you reculture your gut, right? So that's because you are introducing certain strains of microorganisms to keep the balance. So biologically you can manipulate an ecosystem. There's a fourth and there's a fifth, which I'm not allowed to share because I'm bound by confidentiality, which we discovered. And then we mapped, so this is one mental model. There were 11 mental models we mapped. And then on top of that, you map the world's solutions and you realize that physical and chemical is known to the world and is over-leveraged. Every company is using it. Biological is known to the industry and is under-leveraged. And the other two are unknown to the industry and unleveraged. They are blind spots which industry can't see. But the moment you start to map how value is getting created in the industry, value is getting transferred, and value is getting consumed, and what are the value parameters, you start to see what are the boundaries of thinking of that industry. And the internal experts will look back and say, wow, why didn't we think of it before? Imagine there are people working in that industry for centuries, but how come they haven't thought? Because they're wearing blinkers. Maybe they needed someone from outside to come and map it, unscramble the knowledge in a manner that they can start to see the boundaries of thinking and say, of course. You know, these are those, then you start to see new opportunity areas where if you were to work, deep dive, you'll find solutions that could disrupt the industry. Now, these are those obvious in hindsight areas. These areas are obvious in hindsight. You can't see them. But once you see them, you can't unsee them. It's like that. And then people who've been around in the industry for too long, they start to say, how come we didn't see it before? So that's why you need people who have the knowledge. You also need people who can synthesize the knowledge in a manner that you can make new meaning. Synthesizing the knowledge in a new manner is the job of an innovation facilitator. Breakthrough thinking is not a big deal. Synthesis is a big deal. So that's where, now a lot of people ask me, how do you become an innovation facilitator? That's what I tell them. There's no course that's going to teach you that. Because there were no courses, I developed my own methodology, right? So, and I was having this conversation with a couple of your friends who brought me from the airport, who were asking me, where's the scope? I said, what does scope mean? Where's the biggest opportunity? So I asked them, what does opportunity mean? They said, where's the biggest opportunity to make money is where we got to. I said, what if I were to take money out of the equation? Take money out of the equation. Would you still choose that? What is the area you will pick if the money wasn't a factor? That's the question I asked my daughter a few years ago, 7 years ago. Because she says, when she came back from school, she says, all my classmates seem to be too sure of what they want to do. I said, congratulations to them. She said, but I don't know what to do. I said, congratulations, because I feel the same. I don't know what to do. Some people ask me, they say, oh, you're doing well in innovation. Is that what you're going to do? I said, I have no idea. This is what I like right now. Maybe next 2 years later, I'll start writing children's literature, if I like that. Or I'll become a farmer, if I like that. I mean, like, I was a cartoonist once. Then I was an electronics guy once. Then I became an advertising guy. Then I became something else. I mean, you just pick up what you like. Because the moment you start doing what you like doing, imagine, and I asked my daughter this, how about nail chiseling? She says, what's that? I said, I have no idea. Because everyone else out there is going to choose from a menu that is already made. No, they haven't made that menu. There is an engineer there, there's a doctor there, there's management executive there, there's a filmmaker there, there's an RJ there, someone else has made the menu. So first by elimination, then by selection, they'll pick something. But that's not them. And then they'll go to a college, spend 2 years, and hate every Monday that they have to go to college. Hate the exams. Don't worry. They're going to hate it. They're going to, and if there is, say for example, you like something called nail chiseling, there is no college in the world that shows you how to do that. What if there was a college and 10 people go there? They're going to hate every day, but you are going to do it yourself. And you're going to do it with such intensity that within 2 years, you'll be magical. You'll be a master. And therefore, so infectious that the world will start throwing money at you. You won't know what to do with it. Because you'll be the only one in the world who'll be doing it. Others will be hating it. You know, so that's the question I think we all need to ask. As to what areas are we picking up? Why are we picking up the same old jaded areas that the world has taught us to pick up? Let me take you through a Storm the Norm method that I've created for innovation. It's just, I'll take you through the basics of it, which is the 5 stages of Storm the Norm. It can be applied to anywhere. It can be applied to your area of work, or it could be applied to your lives. So how do I change this? Is there a way I can, is there a clicker or is there a computer somewhere? Where is this loaded? Oh, they'll have to do that? Oh, there's a keyboard there. Sorry, I didn't see that. I can't, oh, yeah, okay. All right, okay. Okay, good, good, good. Let's talk about industries. You know, there are 20 stories in the book. No, I don't, it's okay. I don't need a pointer. Oh, there's a clicker too, okay. So there are 20 stories in the book, 20 Indian brands or organizations that have stormed the norms of their industry and have created unprecedented vibrancy. And these are 3 kinds of companies. There are old legacy companies like Times of India and Raymond that haven't lost relevance, or they have reinvented themselves and therefore they've endured. There are challenger companies like even some MNCs like Kurkure from PepsiCo or Fiamma DeWils from ITC or Honda, various companies that were challengers to the when they came in. And then there are some new age companies like PVR and Make My Trip that have changed the world. So all sorts. But there was one thing that was staring at us when we were researching all of these stories, that market storms aren't purely accidental. There's a method to the magic. And we set about finding that method, and that's the method we found. What do you see here? What kind of a map is it? Sorry? World map. Okay, look again. It is a world map. It's upside down. Okay. You know, when we give a printout of a map like this to people, they typically turn it around instinctively. And then they feel that the words have gone upside down. They say there's something wrong with your map. Actually, there's nothing wrong with this map. What are maps? Maps are supposed to be information. They're supposed to tell you which country is where, etc. But maps, after a while, can become mindsets. They become mental models. There's a certain world map we've grown up with that we've seen in our atlases and geography books. If I blindfold any one of you, you'll be able to draw a pretty accurate map. North America, South America, Africa, Asia, Europe, Australia. That's the map, right? If someone changes it, we say that's wrong. Because that's what our school also told us, remember? If you drew a map like that, we got 100 marks. If you drew a map some other way, we got a zero. Because the school told us there's only one right answer. But let me tell you, there are many right answers. For an innovation person, there are many right answers. They're all different perspectives. They're not wrong. We found this atlas this map in an Australian atlas. And there was something written in small print under the map. And I'm going to read that out to you because that shows an interesting mindset we have. It said, "No apologies are called for in presenting the map with South at the top. After hundreds of years of development, the southern lands have no reason to be under the northern hemisphere." A very irreverent thought, very challenging thought. Because Australians love this kind of a world. Because they're not down under anymore. They're in the northern hemisphere. They love it. They're not down south. And actually, what's wrong with a world that looks like this? Nothing wrong. Someone told us that's wrong. It isn't. If I were to tell you the world map is not a fact, it's an opinion. It's an opinion of the people who created it. Or it was either based on their ability or maybe some agenda that they created a map that they did. This is how norms get created. What's the first stage in the storm the norm process? Is this. It's a stale, stagnant market. How do you know that the market is stale and stagnant? The market that you are in, that is. There are signs that the market gives you that tells you that the market is stale and stagnant. You see commoditized offerings. Everything, all offerings are the same. One product, another product, another product, all the same. There's a sea of sameness. You see mindless operations. Too many standard operating procedures. You see wafer thin margins. And you see a very, very depressive discourse happening in the industry saying, it's a very price sensitive market. You can't do this, you can't do that. We've tried this, we've tried that. Nothing works. When you hear all of this, you know you are in a stale market. But how come the incumbents don't know that they are in a stale market? How come? Because they don't sense their own staleness. They've gotten too used to their staleness. It's like you don't see dirt in your own home. When someone else comes and says, oh, that's a dirty mark on your patch on your wall. They say, oh, where? I didn't notice it. The same way incumbents don't sense. It's like sometimes you enter a cab, a taxi, and it's very stuffy inside. And you wonder how was the taxi guy living in it for so long. Because he got used to that staleness. And you say, open the windows, yeah, khidki kholo zara thodi. That's what happens in industries too. Why is it that incumbents don't sense the staleness? I'll tell you a story. There's an interesting story we tell. It's a children's story. There's a pond. And the pond has the pond ecosystem, the flora and fauna of a pond. You know, there are plants, there are fish, there are frogs and everything. These frogs jump out of the pond every once in a while and go out. Being amphibians, they do their stuff and they come back into the water. And they come back with a lot of stories, a lot of interesting stories of this fascinating world outside water. When they tell those stories, the fish is like listening to these stories with rapt attention, saying, wow, that must be a fascinating world. Because the frogs say, when we go out of water, we see plants, we see trees. We see human beings, we see animals, we see this, we see that. And the animals that haven't seen the world outside water are fascinated. So this goes on for a long time. Till one day a baby fish asks a very interesting question. A baby fish that hasn't gotten normed yet asks a very interesting question. It says, frog, when you say you go out of water, you see this and you see that, what's water? Now the frog doesn't know how to tell fish what water is. How do you tell fish what water is? if there's a PhD in water, that should be the fish, right? Was born in water, is going to live in water, is going to die in water. Should know water. But that's when frogs realize something very interesting. That in order to completely know water, one surely must know water. One also must know no water. The question is it possible to completely make sense of your paradigm from within it? When you're breathing and you're a citizen of that paradigm, how do you conceive the next paradigm? Not easy. You know, remember oral care I was talking about? I am a citizen of the world that consumes the oral care products, and I'm happy with them. How do I conceive the next? I'm a slave of this paradigm. How do I conceive the next? So the question we ask a lot of our clients is, if you're a fish, what's your water? What is everywhere, all pervasive? Your existence depends on it, but you don't sense it. But an outsider will come and will be able to sense it. And if there's suboptimality in there, we'll be able to do something about it. Why? Because we have become slaves of those norms. Look at some of the, okay, what does a stormer do? Now, this kind of situation is ripe for a stormer, right? Stormer comes in. Now, stormers don't come, usually come from outside, but not always. It could be an incumbent that could turn into a stormer too, by the way, if it has frog's eyes, that is. Like I said, they ask new questions. Look at some of these companies. Now, a stormer comes and spots the suboptimal. What is a suboptimal? Something that's not right in the system, right? Whether it's the products, processes, business model, or ecosystem architecture, they spot the suboptimal. Look at some of the companies that missed the bus because they were incumbents and they did not see the new coming. We know all of these examples, right? Sony missed the MP3 disruption. You know, in the year that this disruption happened, Sony had spent 10 times more money on R&D than any other company had. But it's not just if you throw resources at your R&D lab, doesn't mean that you will create the next disruption, right? Biggest beverage brands in the world, Pepsi and Coke, missed energy drinks, the disruption that Red Bull brought about. Kodak missed digital. We know that. Travel agents did not foresee online booking coming. Airbnb was a surprise for the hotel industry. Uber, we know these two guys in the garage, how they shook up the whole industry. Three guys in the garage, that is. Biggest of them all, banks. Banks attract the most expensive talent in the world. Most expensive. Banks have missed the last three disruptions in banking. Mutual funds as an idea did not come from banks. Microcredit as an idea did not come from your conventional banks. It came from Grameen Bank, which is not your conventional bank. Cryptocurrencies or the concept of blockchains did not come from banks. In fact, banks dismissed them when it happened. They hated the idea because that made their influence erode. I don't know if I'm, I think because of the noise, I'm not sure if I'm reaching at the back and I'm having to scream a little. I'm good, okay, so I'll talk a little. This is what happens to incumbents. Why? Because they all got normed. Let's do an experiment. We'll do an experiment just now. I'm going to norm you right now. I'll introduce a norm. And within a minute, all of us will become slaves of that norm. Ready? Tayar, challenge ke liye? Alright. I'll give you spellings of some words. And I would like you to scream out the word for me. Yeah? I'll give you spellings, you give me the word. But you have to say it together. If you don't say it together, we'll keep repeating. Till you say it together. Yeah? J-O-K-E. Together. J-O-K-E. Together. J-O-K-E. Everyone. J-O-K-E. Everyone. J-O-K-E. I can see some of you are not speaking. Remember, this is a childlike activity. You'll have to forget your age. And don't bother about hierarchy, that your teachers are here, this, that, another. Just be yourself, okay? Break out of all that shitty stuff. J-O-K-E. J-O-K-E. P-O-K-E. 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 Pepsi's competitor? Pepsi's competitor? Pepsi's competitor? Everyone, Pepsi's competitor? What's the white of an egg called? What's the white of an egg called? What's the white of an egg called? What is it? So what is white called? Egg white? No, albumin. You must be wrong, because the rest of the hall says it's yolk. You're the only one who's saying egg white, albumin, I don't know what. Lekin aap akele bol rahe, dekho sare log to yolk keh rahe hain. Jab main pooch raha hu, what's the white of an egg called? Everyone is saying yolk. Aap kuch aur bolte ja rahe hain. Lekin baki sab galat hai matlab. So what's the white of an egg called? Egg white or albumin, right? Why did it become yolk for us? Hum conditioned ho gaye. I conditioned you. It took me half a minute to condition you guys. It took me half a minute to introduce a norm and make you slaves of that norm. If that was the first question I had asked you, if I came here and say, what's the white of an egg called? No one would have said yolk. No one. But you see how you got hypnotized? That's what happens in industries. When you're doing the same thing quarter after quarter, year after year, you become normed. That's conditioning. There's another very interesting story about a gurukul. A gurukul tha, jisme pata nahi aapne shayad suni hogi. Anyone who doesn't understand Hindi in the hall? Everyone does, right? Okay. No, I come from Bangalore. There I need to ask this question because there are often a few people who don't speak Hindi. And Hindi is my natural language, and I normally, if the audience understands Hindi, that's my preferred language. So Gurukul tha, to usme unki dincharya subah shuru hoti thi puja ke saath. Ek mandir tha Gurukul mein, sab pahunch jate the wahan aur puja hoti thi. Abhi Guruji ke paas ek paltu billi thi. To jab ye puja ho rahi hoti thi, to billi aa jati thi beech mein aur ghumna shuru kar deti thi. Bhai sab puja kar rahe hain. Wo thode distract ho jate the log. To Guruji ne kaha kuch karna padega is problem ke bare mein. तो एक दिन वो जल्दी आ गए, तो एक स्टूडेंट भी आया हुआ था जल्दी, तो उसने कहा बेटा ऐसा करो, बिल्ली को ले जाओ उस पेड़ के साथ बांध दो, जब पूजा हो जाएगी तो खोल देंगे. उसने कहा ठीक है सर, यही करता हूँ. तो वो ले गया, बांध दिया, पूजा हो गई, बड़ी अच्छी रही, सबको लगा बड़ा अच्छा आइडिया है. वो स्टूडेंट रोज बड़ी रिलीजियसली आता, बिल्ली बांधता, पूजा होती और बिल्ली खोल दी जाती. ये चलता रहा हर रोज, फिर हर साल नए स्टूडेंट्स आते थे, सीख जाते थे, बिल्ली बांधो, पूजा करो, बिल्ली खोल दो. तो ये होता रहा, एक दिन गुरुजी का स्वर्गवास हो गया. तो जो सीनियर मोस्ट टीचर था वो गुरुजी बन गया. फिर तो उसने भी वही फॉलो किया, भाई बिल्ली बांधो, पूजा करो, बिल्ली खोलो. एक दिन बिल्ली का स्वर्गवास हो गया, तो सारे एक दूसरे की शक्ल देखने लगे, भैया ये पूजा कैसे करें, बिल्ली तो है नहीं. तो नए गुरुजी ने किसी को भेजा, बेटा जल्दी बाहर से जाओ, एक बिल्ली का जुगाड़ करो. गई, बांधी गई, पूजा की गई, फिर बिल्ली खोली गई. फिर एक स्टूडेंट ने कहा सर ये हम बिल्ली बांधते क्यों हैं? बेटा ये पूजा पूर्ण नहीं मानी जाती जब एक बिल्ली हमारे दाएं ओर बंधी ना हो मंदिर के. तो इस तरह के माइंडलेस रिचुअल्स जो हैं हमारी जिंदगी में आ जाते हैं और हम उसके स्लेव्स बन जाते हैं. हर इंडस्ट्री ऐसी होती है, एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस भी ऐसी होती हैं, कंपनियां भी ऐसी होती हैं, घर भी ऐसे होते हैं, हम भी वैसे होते हैं. हम एक रिचुअलाइज्ड जिंदगी जीते हैं, हमारे को बनाया ऐसे गया है. दिस योग एक्सपेरिमेंट आई हैव डन अक्रॉस कल्चर्स अराउंड द वर्ल्ड, इट्स ऑलवेज योग. दैट्स हाउ क्विकली वी गेट कंडीशन. यू वॉन्ट डू इट अगेन? चैलेंज है. रिमेंबर व्हाट आई सेड, माइंडलेसनेस. व्हाट नॉर्म्ड और पीपल हु गेट्स become slaves of mind, they become mindless. So the shift is from mindlessness to mindfulness. So let's try and be mindful this time. Yeah? S-I-L-K. S-I-L-K.
Same.
Together, S-I-L-K.
Same.
S-I-L-K.
Same.
What do cows drink? What do cows drink? No, all of you are right. They also drink water. They drink milk sometimes. When they're young, they drink milk, I guess. So that's okay. But we are getting there. That's about being mindful. This is how organizations and people, now where did I put that thing? Okay, it's in my pocket. Become normed. Now, when a stormer comes, the stormer spots the suboptimal. What level of suboptimality have you spotted is the question. We'll do a quick exercise to understand levels of suboptimality in different industries. You could a suboptimality which is superficial level, or you could spot a suboptimality which is deeper level. We'll talk about that in a bit. Now, once you have spotted the suboptimal, you know, it's often very easy to find answers if you've discovered a new question, answer is typically usually just staring at you. You know, it's no big deal. In fact, in today's world when the knowledge is so democratized, you just Google everything. Answers is not a problem. Find a new question and you'll find new answers then. That's the thing. So, now this is something software world is teaching the legacy world. That you don't have to wait for the best idea ever. Because if you're going to wait for the best idea ever, you're going to wait forever. Right? So, what is my alpha? Where is my beta? And I don't wait. I take the beta into the market. Gmail beta, this beta, that beta, Facebook beta, 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 Uber beta. Beta goes into the market. And you allow the market to interact with beta. In fact, there are bugs in it. But no one's going to complain because you called it beta. If someone complains, he says, beta tha bhai. Humne aapko pehle hi bataya tha beta tha. Or you should feel privileged that you are a minority who's been given the sneak peek. Or an opportunity to engage with it so people are happy. Then the ecosystem starts to engage with it. And as the ecosystem engages with that beta, it evolves. Because you iterate. You find bugs. You do something about it. You polish it. You iterate to elegance. Now that's how innovations evolve. You iterate to elegance. You reject multiple versions before you hit upon the winning version. There's a difference between simplistic and elegant simplicity. The first idea that comes to your mind is simplistic. It's too simple. Then you go through complexity. You iterate through complexity. The simplicity that emerges on the other side of complexity is elegant simplicity. But there are no shortcuts to elegant simplicity. You have to go through complexity. The only thing you can do is you could rapidly iterate. Rapid prototyping. That's why rapid prototyping. That's why you hear the words in startups. There's a word called pivot. If you find two startup founders talking in a bar somewhere in Silicon Valley or in Bangalore, you know the typical conversation they're having? Other than funding, this, that, and other. They're saying, how many times did you pivot? So we pivoted 7 times. The other one says, what does pivoting mean? Pivoting is, you go out into the market with a value proposition. You're saying, this is my customer segment, this is my pricing, this is my value proposition. And then you realize something else, that you could actually make a value proposition better. Or there's another segment that you never realized existed, which has started to use your product much more than the one that you were targeting. And then you say, maybe the first idea wasn't a great idea, I'll think up a new idea. That makes you challenge your own business model. So you pivot, you pivot, you pivot, and you pivot. That's iteration. So iterating to elegance. Sorry, I'm having to scream somehow. Maybe some, Let me also take this and see if I can. Maybe it's just me. I feel there's noise, so I'm not able to read, so I'm screaming. All right, so let's go to the next stage. The next stage is, So the first stage is stale market, right? Okay, I'll take that microphone. Thank you. So the first is stale markets, stale stagnant markets. Oh, this is better. The second is spot the suboptimal. Third is conceive the breakthrough and iterate to elegance. Fourth one surprised us. It's called pace to critical mass. We realize there are good ideas. There's so many good ideas out there. But why is it that some good ideas succeed while others don't? And we started studying the various examples. Then we found our answer in a very old theory, a theory called theory of innovation diffusion. And we realized that there are some ideas or some companies that are able to generate a pace that hit the critical mass at a pace that creates a wave which creates a storm. Others are not able to create that pace to critical mass. Now the question is, what is critical mass? Now critical mass as a term comes from nuclear physics. You know, atomic or nuclear reactions, you know, they happen when you achieve critical mass. Now critical mass could be maybe 20% consumers in your market or universe, or it could be 10%, or it could be 5% very engaged consumers that you must hit in a given time. That's the pace you must generate. So pace to critical mass. So two questions here. What is the critical mass for your industry? And two is, what pace must you generate? And that is the question that every startup or an organization must answer. Otherwise, your breakthrough will be a lukewarm success. And you won't have, no company in the world has the wherewithal to educate 100% population out there. How many ads will you release to educate the consumer? You have to create that fortuitous, virtuous cycle. And for that, you have to hit the critical mass at a certain pace. We also found some very interesting examples in our case studies of organizations that had actually discovered their critical mass after they entered the market, or they discovered a segment that they didn't know existed. In fact, their critical mass wasn't even their primary target audience, target segment. To give you two examples, Make My Trip is one example. Deep Kalra, who's the startup, who's the founder of Make My Trip, you know, when he started out, he started with assumptions that Indians will have the devices, they'll have the bandwidth, and they'll have the willingness to transact online. But all of these assumptions proved false. Indians didn't have the devices, they didn't have the bandwidth, or they didn't want to transact online, they were scared. They would go to Make My Trip, look at, compare prices, then go to their local guy and say, bhaiya, ye book kar de mere liye. That's what was happening. So, but he realized when the data started to come in, it was gloomy data. But then there was one market, one segment that was turning out to be a very loyal segment. Chota sa segment tha. Uske liye banaya hi nahi tha ye wala product. Ye product Indians ke liye banaya hua tha. Ye the NRIs. Jo itni dur baithe hain. अब उन्हें टिकट बुक करनी है वापस आने के लिए या अपने फैमिली मेंबर्स के लिए, उनके पास तो वो लोकल राजू है नहीं करने के लिए, तो वो ऑनलाइन करते थे. एंड दे ऑल्सो हैड डिवाइसेज, दे हैड द बैंडविड्थ, एंड दे हैड द विलिंगनेस टू इवन ट्रांजैक्ट ऑनलाइन, बिकॉज़ दे वर एनीवे डूइंग इट. दिस वॉज अ स्मॉल सेगमेंट. ऑब्वियसली दिस सेगमेंट वुडंट हैव अलाउड दीज पीपल टू बिकम प्रॉफिटेबल वेरी क्विकली. आई मीन यू वर लुकिंग एट द होल इंडियन मार्केट विच इज ह्यूज. ही स्टॉप्ड ऑल एक्सपेंडिचर इन इंडिया फॉर 5 years. Shifted focus to the US, listed the company in NASDAQ, only focused on NRIs, iterated it to elegance, and by the time he reached a stage where Make My Trip was in a version which was totally elegant, he then started to address the Indian market all over again after 5 years. And India was ready by then. It had the devices, it had the bandwidth, and it had the willingness to transact online. So that's how. There was this another very interesting example of Fiamma DeVille's gel bars. In the gel bar, they created these gel. It's not a soap. They say it's gel, right? But Indians weren't used to gel. I mean, we want a bar of soap and we want to. जब तक वो नहीं आएगी कि क्या लिक्विड है तो सिर पे लगाते हैं लिक्विड यहाँ कहाँ लगाऊं? you know, so they were not buying. So they said, okay, so we have to kind of make it into the form of a something solid that they can rub on themselves. Fine. So gel bar banaye. Unki target audience thi youth, essentially girls. They said they are the youthful people, and this is our primary target audience. When they launched, they realized there was another segment that was using them much more than anyone else was. This was 40-45-year-old women who had recently become aware of their wrinkles on their faces, and they wanted to be youthful. So they were buying. They could have said, oh God, this is spoiling our positioning. We can't be changing our positioning to, that time they said, and very derogatorily, aunties, they said, because we are not an auntie brand, we are a youth brand. They stayed loyal to this segment. I mean, this is what we say. Be loyal to the segment that's using you in spite of your flaws. Because for them, your product was overdue. This segment allowed them to iterate in the market, make it better. And then they were ready for the youth. And anyway, these aunties had their daughters at home, right, who started to use them, and therefore the product became successful anyway. So this is how sometimes you discover. So you don't just do price discovery, you do segment discovery, you do value proposition discovery. Don't be arrogant and say, I'm the innovator, I decide. You don't decide. You only orchestrate the innovation. You're not the innovator. You're orchestrator of the innovation. Because the time is gone when individual maverick individuals, some Einstein sitting there, or some Edison sitting there, or some company called Apple is going to disrupt the market. No, time's gone. The biggest innovator in the world is going to be the ecosystem, not an individual company. It's all going to be collaborative innovation. It'll all be combinatorial innovation. It's called when you bring many building blocks together, that innovation is called combinatorial. And for that, many organizations will need to come together. You know, very, very interestingly, sometimes some people say, who's the smartest person in the room? The smartest person in the room is the room, not a single person. The same way the smartest person in any industry is going to be the ecosystem, not a single company. That's how it's going to be soon. That's the world we live in. And that's why you all are so fortunate. That's why we all are so fortunate. We are in a world which is now being called the gig economy. We don't have to be slaves of the large, only the large corporate. Ki MBA kiya to ek company join karni padegi, wahan par unke slaves banna padega. Roz 9 to 5 karna zaruri nahi hai. Haan, agar karna chahte ho, aapki hobby hai to zarur karo. Lekin nahi karna chahte to bahut zaruri hai ab to. Now two guys in the garage are shaking up the industries, right? So you could be the two guys in the garage shaking up the industry. Can you imagine? Like they say for Airbnb, that the world's biggest hotel company doesn't own a single room. The world's biggest taxi company doesn't own a single car. Uber doesn't own a single car. Imagine, agar kisi ne disrupt karna hota hotels ko, to koi aaye kehta, bhaiya, you'll have to outdo Marriott's of the world and the Holiday Inns of the world and the Sheraton's of the world. Ab aap aoge, aap dekhoge itne bade bade luxury hotels, bhaiya, isko to outdo karna bada mushkil hai. इन्होंने इतने साल और इतने करोड़ रुपए लगाए हैं, उससे डबल तो मैं कहां से लाऊंगा. टू गाइज इन अ गैराज सेड वी डोंट नीड टू ओन एनीथिंग. विद वन फ्रैक्शन ऑफ दैट मनी वी गोइंग टू शेक द इंडस्ट्री, बिकॉज वी गोइंग टू शेक द इंडस्ट्री बिकॉज वी नॉट गोइंग टू डिस्टर्ब ऑन प्रोडक्ट, वी विल गोइंग टू डिस्टर्ब ऑन एक्सेस टू होटल्स. दैट्स व्हाई दे डिड इट, राइट? ऑलराइट, सो लेट मी गो फॉरवर्ड. Yeah, so that is the fourth stage. And the fifth stage, the final stage, is a fresh, vibrant market. Now, you started the stale market, but you brought in the new breakthrough, you created new norms, and all those people, those incumbents who were cynical earlier, who were lazy earlier, who were saying, kuch nahi ho sakta, catch up. Because it's a question of survival, they'll die. The world has changed. But the stormer who came in, who created fresh norms, has also gotten normed now. Because fresh norms at the end of the day are norms. And norms are just a lull before the next storm arrives. The moment you've created new norms, you're the author of the new norms, you become slaves of your norms. This state is ready for a stormer to arrive. It's a cycle. That's what storm the norm cycle is all about. This is how it works. Stale norms, spot the suboptimal, conceive and iterate the breakthrough, pace to critical mass, and fresh norms. When we work with companies, we say, these are the stages we need to go through. First, spot the staleness. Spot the suboptimality. How do you spot the suboptimality? You are a fish. Unless you become a frog, how do you spot the suboptimality? Okay, so we tried to also figure out the science or the economics behind storms. Storms is a metaphor. But how do storms happen? And we found our answer in Economics 101. I'm sure you've heard the term total surplus. I don't know if you've heard the term total surplus in your economics class. Total surplus is the sum of consumer surplus and producer surplus. You know what consumer surplus is? Consumer surplus is the savings. Anyone else? Expenditure. Investments. No. Consumer surplus is simply the maximum price consumer is willing to pay above the market equilibrium price. Agar market equilibrium price 100 hai aur customer 120 dene ko taiyar hai, 20 rupaye ka premium dene ko taiyar hai, to 20 rupaya consumer surplus hai. Producer surplus is the minimum price that the producer is willing to accept below the market equilibrium price. So, un dono ko jod diya jaye, this is a normal demand supply curve. So, consumer surplus plus producer surplus is the total surplus. In a stagnant market, the total surplus is very little. In a vibrant market, the total surplus is very high. So, what the stormers do is they unlock hidden total surplus. Why do we say hidden? Because before they stormed it, no one saw that value. It's like discovering a sone ki khan. Arey, ye kahan hai? Bada sona hai isme to yaar. Ek aur oil well mil gaya. Wo pehle dikhta nahi hai hamare ko. But ek baar dikh jata hai, then gold rush begins. Everyone wants to get there, and then more of the same happens. And then there's a search for the next sone ki khan. Let's look at an example of an industry that has seen two storms in our lifetimes. Actually, almost three storms. Cinema exhibition space. The story in the book, PVR's story. You know, when we were growing up, we used to go to these cinema halls. I mean, I come from a small town. So, cinema halls used to be, aap to Delhi ke rehne wale hain, yahan to bahut acche hote hain cinema halls. Hamare shaharon mein to phati seatein, chuhe ghoom rahe hain, aise type hote the wo. बड़ी गंदा जैसे वो दारू नहीं लेते लोग जैसे हाथ घुसा के वैसे तो टिकट लेते थे ऐसी वैसी जगहें होती थी उसमें 20-20 रुपए में हमें टिकट मिल जाती थी मैंने तो 14 रुपए भी दिए हुए हैं तो आपको आपको समझ आएगा कि मैं कहां से मेरी उम्र क्या है 14 रुपए टिकट के भी दिए हुए वहां पर आपको लगता था यार ये गुप्ता जी कुछ करते क्यों नहीं सिनेमा हॉल का मतलब कुछ करें फैसिलिटीज को तो मतलब लोग भी ज्यादा आएंगे पैसे भी ज्यादा कमाएंगे फिर और अच्छा चलेगा बिजनेस करते क्यों नहीं उनसे पूछो तो वो कहते थे भैया मैं पहले ही लॉस में हूं मैं करूं क्या तो मतलब प्रोड्यूसर सरप्लस बहुत कम है गुप्ता जी अगली फिल्म आ रही है धर्मेंद्र की आप कितना एक्सेप्ट करने को तैयार हैं मार्केट इक्विलिब्रियम प्राइस के नीचे कहते बिल्कुल नहीं मैं पहले ही लॉस में हूं तो अभी 20 रुपए दिए सर अगली वाली के लिए कितना ले सकते हैं चलिए आप इफ यू इंसिस्ट 19 रुपीस 1 रुपया प्रोड्यूसर सरप्लस वो मार्केट रिसर्च वाले पहुंच गए लोगों के पास हमारे जैसे सर 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 आपने अभी धर्मेंद्र की फिल्म देखी अगली बारी आ रही है अब कितना अबव द मार्केट इक्विलिब्रियम प्राइस हाउ मच आर यू विलिंग टू एक्सेप्ट सर नथिंग मेरी पॉकेट मनी से भी ज्यादा है ये तो इफ यू इंसिस्ट मे बी 22 रुपीज कंज्यूमर सरप्लस इमेजिन टोटल सरप्लस ऑफ 3 रुपीज वॉट इफ दैट इज काइंड ऑफ सरप्लस हैपनिंग इन एन इंडस्ट्री that industry becomes a very risk-averse industry. No one wants to experiment. No experiment means no innovation. Look at today. What are people paying? 100 rupees a movie, 150, 200. Delhi wale log to 1000 rupees dete hain gold class ke liye. India ke sabse bigde log to yahi rehte hain na. Wo jaake wo baith jayenge us pe. सो जाएंगे मतलब सोने के लिए जाते हैं वहाँ क्योंकि वो काउच पे बैठे हुए तो नींद ही आएगी ना. वो पापड़ भी ला रहा है क्या कहते हैं उसको नाचो कहते हैं आजकल पापड़ को. तो एनीवे तो वो इमेजिन आई हैव जस्ट वॉच्ड अ मूवी एंड समवन कम्स सर 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 यू जस्ट पेड 100 rupees हाउ मच आर यू विलिंग टू पे फॉर द नेक्स्ट मूवी यू नो शाहरुख खान मूवी कमिंग 150 मूवी कम्स इट्स 100 rupees 50 rupees कंज्यूमर सरप्लस. अजय बिजली सेज आई कैन एक्सेप्ट 70 rupees आई स्टिल मेक प्रॉफिट 30 rupees produces surplus, 80 rupees, that's huge. Now that kind of total surplus is creating a very vibrant market. Lots of experiments, different genres of movies, different kinds of producers, different kinds of actors, directors. Amazing, isn't it? It's a vibrant market. Now this vibrant market is ready to be stormed again. The barbarians are at the gate already. OTT, over the top. Technologies like Netflix are here. अगर मैं साल की 10 फिल्में देखता हूं तो मैं कहूंगा आई वॉन्ट टू वॉच 8 मूवीज ऑन माई ऑन द डिवाइस ऑफ माई चॉइस एट द टाइम ऑफ माई चॉइस एट द प्लेस ऑफ माई चॉइस ऑन Netflix. 2 मूवीज में बड़े पर्दे पर देखूंगा भैया वो तो बनता है. सो विच मीन्स दिस इंडस्ट्री इज रेडी टू लूज 80% ऑफ इट्स बिजनेस इवन बिफोर वी कुड से Netflix. There's going to be Amazon Prime, which is going to bundle shopping with it. So the next storm is already brewing. आजकल तो ये ज़माना आ गया कि storm को मौका ही नहीं मिलता पूरे अपने परवाज लेने का. Before it can get to its peak, the next storm is already brewing. That's the kind of world we are living in. It's a dynamic world. ये भी एक कहानी Disney की. डिज्नी की पहली नहीं 1930s में एक एनिमेशन फिल्म आई थी 1 घंटा 20 मिनट की थी. उसका नाम था 3 Little Pigs. बहुत मशहूर और बॉलीवुड हॉलीवुड में आपने देखा होगा व्हेन अ फिल्म बिकम्स अ सक्सेस व्हाट हैपेंस रीमेक ओके सीक्वल्स बनते हैं उसके रिपीट्स बनने शुरू हो जाते हैं. So the team sat down together and said, what should the next film be? So what do you think the next film was? It was a pig film. It failed. If you go to their website, you'll see they made 3 pig films. All 3 failed. They bombed at the box office. Walt Disney was alive then, you know. The visionary himself. So he was taking a morning walk. He writes about it, this whole thing in his autobiography, by the way. So he was taking a morning walk and then suddenly got an epiphany, you know, a realization. And he rushed back to his office and called the whole team and said this. If you Google this sentence, you'll find that story. You can't top pigs with pigs. He was telling his teams, that if you want to do something different, you can't beat pigs with pigs. You got to create something else. Now, this sounded very simple, but what he was saying was something very interesting. That you are exploring like a curious child till you're failing. Because when you're failing, you're saying, if this didn't work, what else will work? What else will work? What else will work? But you do that only till you succeed. Because the moment you succeed, you say, this is the only way to succeed. You get normed. You become slaves of that norm. So your success traps you more than failure ever can. Failure won't trap you as much as your success can trap you. आप जितने भी successful लोग दुनिया में देखते हो, आपको लगता है कि यार ये तो शाहरुख है और ये वो है, ये वो है, ये वो है, वो सारे अपने success formula में trapped हैं. Why do you think you suddenly find people wanting to meet a psychiatrist and committing suicides? Because we live in a pressure cooker world where people have to then live up to. Kapil Sharma goes off air because he's now not able to deal with the kind of pressures because they all got trapped in their successes. So the team sat down and said, what should the next film be? And so what he was trying to tell the team was, go back to zero. Learn from your successes, learn from your failures, but go back to ab initio. Don't be legacied by your assumptions. Then you are an incumbent. That's one way of becoming a stormer. Fresh eyes, frog's eyes, ab initio. So the next film they made was Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. That was a huge film. Top grosser for many years. A full-length animation film. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Now, Walt Disney learned his lesson. You know, pigs say Snow White kaise banaya jaye. Lekin dekhiye, hum kis duniya mein rehte hain? Hum aisi duniya mein rehte hain. Hum suaron ki duniya mein rehte hain. Kisi bhi departmental store mein jaoge to aapko aise brands dikhai denge. Isme gino, ye sab digestive biscuits hain, digestive biscuits. Panch brands hain isme. Dikhai deti hain panch. Sab ek jaisi lagti hain. क्योंकि हम पिग्स की दुनिया में रहते हैं, सारी कंपनियां एक जैसी हैं. हर कंपनी में जब ये लॉन्च करने की बारी आई होगी तो उन्होंने कहा होगा, लेट्स फॉर्म अ क्रॉस फंक्शनल टीम एंड लेट्स लॉन्च अ कैटेगरी क्रिएटिंग प्रोडक्ट विच विल डिसरप्ट द मार्केट. बड़ी बड़ी बातें हुई होंगी बोर्ड रूम्स में. सीईओ ने एक सीएफटी बनाई होगी, क्रॉस फंक्शनल टीम. एचआर डिपार्टमेंट ने उनको प्रिविलेजेस दी होंगी. ये इनोवेशन टीम का रूम है, उसमें बड़े व्हाइट बोर्ड्स रखे होंगे, बड़े अच्छे अच्छे बीन बैग्स भी होंगे, पीले पीले बॉल्स भी होंगे, स्ट्रेस बस्टर्स. कहेंगे भैया आपको टाइम मिलेगा, आपको बोनस भी मिलेगा, गो डिसरप्ट द मार्केट, थिंक ऑफ ग्रेट आइडियाज. सबने सोचे होंगे आइडियाज डी बोनो को फॉलो करके. 50 आइडियाज से 20 आइडियाज, 20 से 10 आइडियाज, 10 से 2 आइडियाज. ये आइडिया हम मैनेजमेंट के पास लेके जाएंगे. उन्होंने वो पीपीटी डेक बनाने में जितना टाइम, जितना सोचने में लगाया था, उससे ज्यादा पीपीटी डेक लगाने में, बनाने में लगाएंगे पहले वो रात भर बैठ के, और फिर प्रेजेंट करेंगे. धक 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 हो रहा होगा. एंड देन टू बी पोलाइट द बॉस विल से वाओ माय टीम इज अमेजिंग. क्योंकि एचआर डिपार्टमेंट ने बोला होगा पहले ही, सर ज्यादा गलत फलत मत बोलना, उनका मोरल डाउन हो जाएगा. वेरी गुड, नाउ वी विल पुट द बेस्ट टीम ऑन इट एंड वी विल लॉन्च दिस प्रोडक्ट. And then they'll call the ad agency. You know, this is not a usual brief. So don't put your usual people. Put your best people on it. Because we're going to change the world with this. Ad agency bhi phir pitch hoti hai, aati hai, jaati hai, kai iterations hue. Great. Good positioning. Good packaging. Good advertising. Let's launch it. Crores of rupees. Product aaya. Jab wo shop floor pe pahuncha yahan par, shelf pe. तो उसके साथ वाला भी उसके जैसा था, उसके साथ वाला भी उसके जैसा था, उसके साथ वाला भी उसके जैसा. कितनी अजीब सी बात है ना. फिर वो कहते हैं कहीं ना कहीं सेबोटाज, एस्पियोनाज, बड़े बड़े वर्ड्स यूज होंगे. कहां लीक हुआ? तुम फोटोकॉपी कहां से कराते हो? वहां देखो, कंपटीशन ने वहां से चुरा लिया, किसी ने व्हाट्सएप कर दिया, इसके अंदर सिक्योरिटी यहां पर लैप्स हुआ है हमारा. कुछ नहीं हुआ. सारे लोग बेचारे एक जैसे घरों में पैदा होते हैं, एक ही जैसे तरीके से जैसे स्कूलों में जाते हैं, वहाँ सुअर बन जाते हैं, फिर उससे भी बड़े सुअर बनने कॉलेजों में जाते हैं, फिर उससे भी बड़ा सुअर बन के स्लेव्स बनने के लिए कॉर्पोरेट वर्ल्ड में जाते हैं, फिर वो सोचना शुरू करते हैं तो ऑब्वियसली एक ही जैसी चीज़ें निकलेंगी ना. तो हैरान होने की बात ही नहीं, हम सब सुअर हैं. होता तो ऐसे ही है. तो ऐसी वाली दुनिया में एक तो होपलेसनेस है कि कुछ नहीं हो सकता, दूसरा अपॉर्चुनिटी है. यहां यूनिक होने के लिए कुछ ज्यादा नहीं करना पड़ता क्योंकि सब एक जैसे. थोड़ा सा अलग और तुम छा गए. आसान है. तो सुअर भी स्नो वाइट बन सकता है. कंपनियां तो दे लिव इन डिल्यूजन. They'll create a pig and put a makeup on the pig to make it look like a Snow White. या कई बार product innovation अच्छी है, लेकिन go to market वही सड़ी गली, पुरानी plumbing, वही distributor, वही retailer. तो आप एक Snow White को जब पुरानी pipelines, plumbings में से push करोगे, जो वहां से निकलेगा ना उस side से, वो pig बन के निकलता है. तो फिर कहते हो अच्छा यही था जो मैंने हमने conceive किया था, वो तो ताबड़ तोड़ तोड़ू product था, ये क्या आ गया, ये तो उसके साथ जैसा ही दिख रहा है. वो यही होता है. her department, whether it's product department or packaging department or operations department or manufacturing department, will take away 5% out of it. नहीं नहीं चलो 100 नहीं हो सकता तो 95 भी ठीक है. हर एक आदमी 5-5% निकाल देगा, वो बचेगा वही 60, वो पहले ही मार्केट में जो 55 है, तो क्या फर्क हुआ. Everyone pulls it down to the level of practicality, and the moment you do that, you've lost the opportunity to disrupt the market with something unique, because what you've got is a pig while you started off trying to make a Snow White. It's not just products and strategies, it's even people become pigs after a while. They start looking like each other. I mean, that's the model we're following, like, right? स्कूलों में सबको यूनिफॉर्म पहना के बोलते हैं ना, एक ही जैसे हो जाओ सारे. आजकल मैनेजमेंट स्कूल्स में भी हफ्ते में एक दिन रखा हुआ है, सबको सूट बूट पहना के खड़ा कर देते हैं. हम कहते हैं भैया क्यों सूट बूट पहनाते हो, भाई उनको प्रैक्टिस करवा रहे हैं क्योंकि आगे जाके सूट पहनने पड़ेंगे. अच्छा, मतलब क्या बात है भाई. वो जमाने गए जब हम लोग जब बड़े हो रहे थे, तो बीच में एक ऐसा टाइम आया था तब वो सूट बूट वाली बात नहीं होती. तब एचआर डिपार्टमेंट के ऊपर कहता था, वी नीड टू गेट फ्रेश ब्लड इन टू द मार्क इन टू द कंपनी, यू नो वी बीन हायरिंग सेम काइंड ऑफ पीपल फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम फ्रॉम द आर ओन इंडस्ट्री, लेट्स गेट सम न्यू काइंड ऑफ पीपल. सो द एचआर डिपार्टमेंट वुड लुक एट द बेस्ट कॉलेजेस आउट देयर, और दे वुड गो टू द अदर इंडस्ट्री टू पिकअप, एंड नाउ द न्यू किड्स हु वुड कम, दे वुड लुक डिफरेंट. मतलब जीन्स पहनी है, टी शर्ट पहनी है, कुछ समझ ही नहीं आ रहा क्या पहना है. वो आ जाते हैं अंदर ऐसे करके, कंघी भी नहीं की हुई, आज सोके कब उठे थे टाइप. वैसे वाले लोग कई बार हमने जब नई नई कंपनियां ज्वाइन की थी, वैसे वाले भी आने शुरू हुए थे आफ्टर आई हैड स्पेंट सम 10-15 इयर्स इन द कॉर्पोरेट वर्ल्ड. दीज काइंड्स ऑफ पीपल केम एंड दे वुड कम एंड दे वुड बी वेयरिंग जीन्स, वुड बी, तुम्हें समझ नहीं आता ये व्हाट्स होल्डिंग अप द जीन. वो यहां पर जीन्स होती थी, इज एज इफ दे आर बीइंग हेल्ड अप बाय विल पावर और समथिंग ओनली. सो दोस काइंड्स ऑफ पीपल कम, बट दे आर दे यूज्ड टू बी वेरी एक्साइटेड, आई एम ज्वाइनिंग दिस बिग कंपनी, यू नो दे आर लाइक बुशी टेल्ड एंड bright eyed squirrels almost, you know, and they, I'm joining this company, I'll make a career out of it, very very excited. But then they would ask questions, sir why do we do it like this. Oh no, actually they won't say sir, they would call you by first names. Ranjan, why do we do it like this, why can't we do it like that, why do we, and people who spend 10 years 15 years in the industry, they look at them and say, god, what is that. You look at the HR department, something wrong with your policy, what are you hiring, they ask too many questions. HR department would say, don't worry, and almost like hunter induction. Then they would make them go through induction, unko pehle padhao, injection do, is industry mein aise hota hai, this is how sales happens, okay okay, this is how marketing happens, okay okay, don't ask questions. And then 1 week in marketing, 1 week in the field, 1 week with the manufacturing, 1 week in factory, mar mar ke uska dumba bana diya. And then he comes and says, now think new ideas. The poor guy, the bushy tail's gone, the bright eyes are gone, the only thing he manages is oink. And then people say, yeah, now you speak our language, now we understand that language. This is what is happening in the world today. But look at the amazing opportunity we have. We don't have, just because we've joined a company of pigs, we don't have to become pigs. We can take our eccentricities, our uniqueness into these companies and take our freshness into these companies rather than join their staleness, or create our own companies. Apni clay se banayenge, usko kisi aur ki tarah hona nahi padega, and those companies won't be poor copies of the existing companies. They'll be unique, their own, right? तो वो वाला जमाना अब आ गया है, पहले भी था, हम लोग करते नहीं थे, वो अलग बात है ना, हमने तो कंपनियां ज्वाइन कर ली थी जाके. So that's spot. Now let's look at how do we spot the suboptimal. Okay, first let me do a time check. What time did we begin? 1 o'clock, right? 1:15, whatever. 1:30. Okay. So I will do a quick exercise to understand. There's a technique of unscrambling thinking. So I'm going to introduce that, because I promised to Tripti that I will also introduce at least one technique so that people can carry that back with you. Okay, I'm going to ask you a question. And you need to answer that question, right? Quickly, like popcorn, everyone. What all do you observe in the room? Quickly. Me, what else? Fan, projector, tables, mic, whiteboard, room, AC. Okay, right, very good, very good. Now, close your eyes, all of you. Close your eyes. Arey bhaiya, aankhe band kar lo. You are safe. I am assuring you, you are pretty safe. Haan, Delhi mein you can't be so sure, right? All right. Keep your eyes closed. What do you observe in the room? Anji, nothing? Air. How do you observe the air? You feel it. What else? Kiski sound? Meri. Fan ki. What else do you observe? Huh? आप सुन रहे हो मैं बोल रहा हूं और जोर से बोलो भाई तो बोलोगे जोर से बोलोगे कि जय माता दी हाँ जी जोर से बोलो व्हाट एल्स यू ऑब्जर्व सॉरी ब्रीदिंग ओके यू ऑब्जर्व योर ब्रीदिंग व्हाट एल्स अपनी आवाज सुन रहे हैं कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि हमें क्या सुनाई दे रहा है अंदर से क्या आवाज आ रही है डार्कनेस अंधकार और बताओ आंखें बंद रखो भाई तुम मेरी शक्ल देख रहे हो व्हाट एल्स यू ऑब्जर्व देखो सोने का मौका दे रहा हूं जवाब देते रहो Okay, open your eyes. Let's try and decode what was happening here. All right. I said, what do you observe? That's what I said, what do you observe? And what were some answers I got? Tables, projector, people. Fan, etc., etc. These are some representative answers, right? If these were answers, let's work back from the answer to question. If these were answers to a question, what do you think the question should have been? What's there in the room? What else? What do you find in the room? What else? What do you see? What do you surrounded with? Okay. So let's say, what do you see? If I ask this question, I get these answers. Right? Now these are ideas. And these are tracks of thinking. This is a track of thinking. When I go down this C track, somewhere while I was saying what do you observe, you heard me say what do you see. That's why you answered this question. And the moment we close the eyes, we suddenly started to hear. We started to feel the air. If I had persisted, maybe all senses would have opened up, smell, taste, etc. These are tracks of thinking. And when I observe through this window, I will observe these things. When I observe through this window, I will observe different things, maybe some same things too. I'll observe the fan here, but I'll also observe the fan here, but differently. When I observe through this, I observe different things. Different here and different here. If I were to get a bunch of people into this room and if I were to ask them to innovate the room, I won't be surprised if they were to only change things they can see. Arrangement badal do, iska rang badal do, carpet ka rang badal do, kursiyan badal do. उसको देख सकते हैं. What if we were to spend 5 minutes thinking about what all can be changed that we can see? What all can be changed that we can only hear, but not see maybe? What all can be changed that we can feel? What all can be changed that we can smell or not smell? Because non-manifestation is also manifestation. It's present by its absence, some things. What all can we taste that we can change, right? So, 5 minutes lagayenge, and then we could pick maybe a few things from each. We will transform the room in a manner that we can't even imagine. It'll feel different. It'll sound different. It'll have vibrations of different kinds. Imagine. It'll taste different. Lekin hum aisa sochte nahin. In hindsight, this makes sense to think in all tracks. But somehow, we all gravitate towards using only one track of thinking or limited tracks of thinking, right? So, thinking happens at 3 levels. Idea or solutions, tracks, and third level is what is called mental model or paradigm. इस 3 levels पे thinking होती है. लोग jumbled thinking करते हैं. इंडस्ट्रीज में भी जब आप जाएंगे कंपनी ज्वाइन करने, वो जो आपके बॉसेस होंगे वो लिमिटेड ट्रैक्स में सोच रहे होंगे, वो जंबल्ड थिंकिंग कर रहे होंगे. एक ही लिस्ट में कुछ सॉल्यूशंस भी होंगे, उसमें कुछ ट्रैक्स भी होंगे, उसमें कुछ मेंटल मॉडल्स भी होंगे. वो एक ही साथ होता है, अनस्क्रैम्बल नहीं करते, स्क्रैम्बल्ड होता है. आपको एग्जाम्पल देता हूं. एक बहुत साल पहले बैंक्स डिसाइडेड टू कंप्यूटराइज. You know, I was growing up, we were in college that time when, you know, public sector banks decided to computerize. I mean, they would very proudly put up that board outside saying, fully computerized branch. Uspe thode wo phoolon ka haar bhi laga hota tha, ye wo. Andar jaake kya dikhta tha? Same people, working the same way, following the same processes, same mindsets and everything. The only thing was, files had been replaced by computers. तो आपने पुराना सिस्टम, पुराने ट्रैक्स ऑफ थिंकिंग, पुराना पैराडाइम लेके यू स्लैप्ड अ न्यू सॉल्यूशन ऑन टॉप ऑफ दैट. कंप्यूटर स्लैप कर दिया. बहुत सालों बाद समवन ब्रॉट 3 fields टुगेदर, बैंकिंग, आईटी एंड टेलीकॉम. किसी ने इन सबको मिला दिया और एटीएम बन गया. एटीएम वॉज ए डीपर लेवल शिफ्ट. एटीएम वॉज ए डीपर लेवल शिफ्ट. इट वॉज अ ट्रैक शिफ्ट. इफ टुडे अ बैंक वर टू कम आउट विद एन एड दैट सेज माय एटीएम इज 10% फास्टर और माय एटीएम हैज 1 new feature, इट ऑल्सो डज दिस, डू यू थिंक इट विल बी अ ट्रैक शिफ्ट? It'll be a solution or idea shift, not a track shift. Because track has already shifted. What would be a track shift in banking today? Bitcoins. Cryptocurrencies is deeper. That reaches mental model stage level. So when we say mobile banking or whatever, you know, internet banking and all, I mean, these are track shifts for sure. Wallets, these are track shifts. So, how do you reach mental model level? You ask yourself, what is the most fundamental truth on which this industry architecture or industry system sits? A truth that we've taken so for granted that we haven't questioned, without which the industry won't exist. So what would be that truth on which banking sits today? What is the truth? More fundamental truth. Security, okay. What else? Any other answers? Convenience, okay. Go deeper. Okay, multiplying of your money. Cashless. See, ye formats badal rahe hain aap. Aap plastic money keh rahe hain, aap paper money hai, plastic money hai, cashless hai. Wo sab cheeze, you are challenging or questioning the format of currency. What if you were to challenge or question currency itself and say, why is currency needed? Why do we need a unit of value that is universally acceptable called currency? Then you go to the history and you say there used to be barter earlier. You know, you grow wheat and I wear shoes. You grow wheat and I make shoes. You need shoes, I need wheat. We're good. But there will be a time that comes when I need wheat but you don't need shoes. How do we do that? So they said, okay, let's come up with a unit of value that's universally acceptable. Now, when you talk this language, you see this language sounds very abstract. A unit of currency which is universally acceptable. Aise koi baat karta hai? Log kehte hain rupaye hain, paise hain, currency hai. But ye sab mental models hain hamare. Jab tak hum inko decode nahi karenge. Now, when you go to that level of abstraction, you sound abstract. But when you have to think at that level, you need to go to that level of abstraction. Otherwise, thinking in ideas is easy, it's simple. Because ideas exist everywhere in the world. This is an idea. A whiteboard marker is an idea. A microphone is an idea. A phone is an idea. A clicker is an idea. क्योंकि ये सामने है हमारे, प्रत्यक्ष दिखता है हमारे को, इसके बारे में बात करना आसान है. सोचो, अभी हम कहते हैं कार, मैंने बोला कार, आप समझ गए. अगर मैं बोलूंगा मैं लेट हो गया क्योंकि भैया मेरा पेट्रोल खत्म हो गया था, आप समझ जाएंगे. इमेजिन यही वाली बात 5000 साल पहले हो रही होती या कुछ साल पहले. चाणक्य बैठे हैं, कौटिल्य, चंद्रगुप्त मौर्य बैठे हैं और मैं लेट हो गया मीटिंग पे, मैं आया. वो सर मेरी कार पेट्रोल खत्म हो गया था सर, वो लेने गया था. क्या कार? कार क्या बोला पुत्र तुमने? सर वो कार, वो जो कार होती है ना सर, पहिए लगे होते हैं. क्या पहिए? अच्छा जैसे रथ है ना, वो सामने सर रथ रथ है सर, वो डब्बा होता है सर, डब्बा होता है. अच्छा 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 अच्छा. वो पेट्रोल, पेट्रोल वो क्या है? वो सर वो जो पानी की तरह होता है ना सर, उसमें डालते हैं. क्या नहाते हैं क्या उसमें? नहीं सर, उसको वो जलाते हैं. उसको जलाते हो? पानी को जलाते हो? वो कैसे कर? देखो कितना मुश्किल हो रही है समझाने में. हमने कार बोला, सब समझ गए, क्योंकि ये हमारा मेंटल मॉडल है. हम जिस दुनिया में पैदा हुए हैं वहां पहले से मेंटल मॉडल बने हुए हैं. अगर आपको उसको क्वेश्चन करना है तो आपको उन चीजों को क्वेश्चन करना पड़ेगा, उन डेफिनेशंस को क्वेश्चन करना पड़ेगा जिसको कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं कर रहा है. दैट्स व्हाई इट्स सो डिफिकल्ट टू टॉक एट अ लेवल ऑफ एब्स्ट्रैक्शन. You have to make the implicit explicit. मुश्किल है, लेकिन एक बार वो भाषा आ जाए तो बड़ा मजा आता है. हर चीज आपको ट्रांसपेरेंट दिखने लगती है जो ओपेक होती है. फिर आपको अपॉर्चुनिटी एरियाज दिखाई देने शुरू हो जाते हैं, क्योंकि सारी दुनिया तो ऐसे ही सोचती है एक ट्रैक पे. और आप कहते हो अच्छा, ये सवाल सारे मैंने सवाल पूछा, व्हाट डू यू ऑब्जर्व, ये जवाब आए. इन जवाबों में पैटर्न क्या है? पैटर्न ये है कि ये एक ट्रैक पे चल रहे हैं सी. अगर सी है तो और ट्रैक कौन से हो सकते हैं? मैं एक लेवल नीचे आया, और ट्रैक कौन से हो सकते हैं? ओके, हियर, स्मेल, टेस्ट, फील, ओके, वेरी नाइस. देन नाउ लेट मी यूज दिस ट्रैक टू कम अप विद अ न्यू आइडिया, एंड आई फाइंड समथिंग सो रिफ्रेशिंगली डिफरेंट. बट वी नीड टू मैप इट एट दैट लेवल. वी नीड टू मैप इट इन अ मैनर दैट The various tracks I find are mutually exclusive and collectively they are exhaustive. Now see, hear, smell, taste, feel are mutually exclusive, collectively exhaustive. Me, see. Only when you reach that level have you reached a level of mapping which is complete and elegant. Otherwise you are thinking ad hoc, atkal pachu. जैसे ज्यादातर इंडस्ट्रीज करती हैं. अगर आपको कंप्लीटली सोचना है, इमेजिन इफ यू वर टू टेक द होल इंडस्ट्री इकोसिस्टम एंड यू मैप एवरीथिंग एट दैट लेवल, वैल्यू क्रिएशन, वैल्यू ट्रांसफर, वैल्यू कंजम्पशन, वैल्यू पैरामीटर्स, and do all tracks of thinking, you've completely mapped the industry at a level of abstraction. And then you map the current products on top of it, like I was saying, oral care, and you start to see where the opportunities lie. But imagine, no one's doing that. Because no one in our school taught us that. They were too busy teaching us physics, chemistry, math. And no one was teaching us, they were busy giving us knowledge. No one wanted to even tell us how to go seek knowledge and synthesize knowledge and map knowledge. वो किसने सिखाया ही नहीं, भूल ही गए, क्योंकि सिखाने वाले ही नहीं जानते थे क्यों सिखा रहे हैं. किसी टीचर को पढ़ने पूछते, आप हमें ये पढ़ा क्यों रहे हो बेटा, क्योंकि करिकुलम में है. नहीं, अच्छा करिकुलम में मान लिया, लेकिन पढ़ा क्यों रहे हो? क्योंकि तुम्हें एग्जाम पास करना है ना बेटा, इसलिए. तो एग्जाम क्यों पास करना है बेटा तुम, नहीं तो आगे पैसे भी तो कमाने हैं ना, इसलिए. तो सारे ही वही एक ही थैली की चट्टे बट्टे, कोई सोच ही नहीं रहा. So three levels of thinking. In fact, there is a field, a profession that has taken this thinking, that has made it into a science and art form. Forensics. There's a field called ratiocination, where you work back from the manifestation. You find a dead body there. Now you work back from that into various kinds of tracks that would have, might have led to that situation. Those people. Actually, today's companies, if they need anyone, they need forensic experts. They don't need managers. Because what will managers do? They'll just about manage. Kuch disruption hogi, wo manage kar lenge. Manage kar rahe. Beta, manage kar lena thoda. To manager ban jate hain jaake. So what we need are forensic experts that are able to decode stuff at that level and create new. All right. So three levels. Now in most projects that we do, we actually, this takes a lot of time, sometimes often months. That oral care project I was talking about, it took us 4 months to map the boundaries thinking together with that team. They have the knowledge, we have the methodology, we work together and we create a map that no one's seen before. That's what needs to be done. So there are three most fundamental questions any company or any individual must answer. One is the why question. Why question is, what's the purpose of our existence? Why are you making toothpaste? Because we make toothpastes. It can't be that. There has to be a why, purpose for your existence. If that's not there, then everyone is going to hate to come on Mondays. Agar why clear hai, everyone will rush to the office because they want to. They're connected with the why. Right? That's the purpose. Then there is the what question. What is, if that is our why, our purpose, then what are the offerings that we must take into the market, our products and services, that will help us achieve our why, our purpose? And what's the how question? If these are our products, how? What are the business and technology formats that will allow us to offer these to the market? These are the most fundamental questions. In fact, you'll be surprised that the companies that we work with, when we ask them, when was the last time you asked these three questions together as a leadership team, they don't even remember. They'll only keep doing some mission vision exercises that where you only scratch the surface and come back from those expensive off sites and you don't do nothing. So whenever there's an innovation project, we ask just these three questions. We map why boundaries, we map what boundaries, and we map how boundaries. I just finished a project with Whirlpool, where we are trying to create a new category, and we mapped all of these boundaries, and there was a global team. There were some people from India, some from other Asian countries like China and other places, also from US and Europe. Together, imagine if, you know, there's a lot of talent in our industry. People are really good and intelligent. You know, it's not that people aren't intelligent. It's just that if we bring a new methodology, everyone follows that, amazing stuff happens, but no one bothers. People are too busy running after targets. No one pauses to even think and talk, you know, discuss stuff. This, for example, is the purpose of one company. Can you guess? Anji? Wikipedia nahi hai. गूगल है. इमेजिन इस कंपनी का पर्पस गैराज से अभी तक यही रहा है, एक्सेप्ट फॉर दैट थिंग इन द ब्रैकेट दैट वॉजंट देयर. उनका पर्पस हमेशा से था टू ऑर्गेनाइज द वर्ल्ड्स इंफॉर्मेशन एंड मेक इट यूनिवर्सली एक्सेसिबल एंड यूजफुल. सोचो दो तीन लड़के मिलके अपने गैराज में कहें कि हम दुनिया की सारी नॉलेज को ऑर्गेनाइज करेंगे, इंफॉर्मेशन को. लोगों ने हंसा होता उनके ऊपर, अरे बेवकूफ साले, मतलब कि बात क्या करते तुम दो फटी हुई जीन्स अगले मील के लिए पैसा नहीं और कहते हो दुनिया की ऑर्गेनाइज. बट दैट्स द पावर ऑफ न्यू थिंक टुडे. दोज पीपल मैनेज्ड इट एंड टुडे दे हैव टू पुट दैट थिंग इन द ब्रैकेट बिकॉज they've realized that they've become the most influential company in the world. And when you become that influential, that kind of obscene influence, it's easy to be evil, you know. So just to remind themselves that they shouldn't be evil, they put that in the bracket. That's the purpose. That's the power of the purpose. Now, is Google today what they had imagined when they were in the garage? No. It's pivoted many times. But the purpose has remained the same. The products and offerings and processes have changed. That's the power of a purpose. How do you reach a purpose? You don't pull it out of a hat like a rabbit. This is how you reach a purpose. You first ask yourself, what is a cultural tension in our world that I feel strongly about? A cultural tension in the world that I feel strongly about. For them, the cultural tension they felt strongly about was access to information and knowledge is not seamless and fair today. For them, there were two things they felt strongly about: seamlessness and fairness. It's not seamless. If anyone wants information, they don't know where to look for it. It's not easy to get. Fairness. Only a minority had access to the best colleges in the world or best educational institutions. Majority didn't. So it was unfair. So they wanted to change that. So therefore, what is the future impact they wanted to create? Democratization of knowledge and information using technology. And therefore, their purpose was to organize the world. That's how you reach a purpose. In fact, each one of you could be asking this question of yourselves. When you're choosing a career, just because someone came for campus placement and just because you happen to be in the room and they selected you, doesn't mean you have to join the company, right? Thing is, what's your purpose? What's your why? And unless you connect your why and the company that you're joining, their why are connected, it's going to be drudgery. After the first few honeymoon period, you'll say, hell, it's Monday. Really? That's what happened. फिर कहोगे पैसा कमाने के लिए तो करना ही पड़ता है. सो दैट्स द व्हाई क्वेश्चन. देयर आर अदर कंपनीज टू, दे हैव देयर अमेजिंग व्हाइज, द पर्पसेस, बट दैट्स अ वेरी बिजी स्लाइड, आई विल जस्ट स्किप इट. देयर आर सम रियली इंटरेस्टिंग वंस. उबर, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन एज रिलायबल एज रनिंग वाटर एवरीवेयर फॉर एवरीवन. एक और वाई बड़ा अच्छा था, बड़ा अच्छा इंटरेस्टिंग एग्जाम्पल है वाई का. वो था जब जॉन एफ कैनेडी, यूएस प्रेसिडेंट जो था, व्हेन ही मेड दैट फेमस स्पीच, वी विल पुट अ मैन ऑन द मून. गूगल करो आपको स्पीच मिल जाएगी. वी विल पुट अ मैन ऑन द मून, ही सेड इन 10 years टाइम. द होल, इट वॉज जस्ट नासा, द होल कंट्री वॉज गैल्वनाइज्ड. इट कैप्चर्ड एवरीवन्स इमेजिनेशन. सो वाओ, वी विल पुट अ मैन ऑन दैट प्लेस अप देयर. Not just America, the whole world was galvanized. To an extent that citizens of America, even while going through recession, were ready to pay more taxes because they wanted to put the man on the moon. Aisa hota hai purpose. Waisa nahi hota jaisa companies banati hain. We want to be the most customer facing, most innovative, blah 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 company in the world. Kisi ko yaad nahi hota. Wahan company mein jaake poocho kisi corridor mein, bete tumhara kya mission hai, vision kya hai company ki? आज सर कुछ था सर, एक मिनट आओ सर, वो उसमें हमारे कॉन्फ्रेंस रूम में, वहां ले जाएगा, वहां पर लगा होगा सर, वो पढ़ लो जरा. बिग वर्ड्स, but they don't connect with the heart. No one understands. What kind of a purpose is that? This is a purpose that galvanizes everyone. So, kahani ye hai ki John F. Kennedy NASA gaya. Ab wo kahani kitni sach hai, kitna marketing ya urban legend hai, I have no idea. But it is an interesting, inspiring story. He goes to NASA. Meeting ho rahi thi NASA ke saath, review ho raha tha. Uske baad he went to the toilet. And in the toilet there was this janitor. Janitor is the sweeper in the toilet who takes care of, who cleans after you. So, hum Indians to baat hi nahi karte na, kya hai sweeper se kya baat karni. Hum to, wahan to dignity of labor hai, everyone is equal, right? So, he made this polite conversation with, how are you doing today and all that with the janitor. And he said, what do you do? What's your job? Generally, he asked. And you know what the janitor said? This is what he said. I'm helping to put a man on the moon. Interesting, isn't it? Even the janitor can connect with the purpose. He's right. If he were not to do his job, the man on the moon will not go on the moon. He'll stay there, right? I mean, jokes apart, but the thing is, when everyone connects with the purpose is when you have a great, compelling purpose. Uske baad, the life becomes a dream, right? It's not a job. Oh, ye kya gaya? Galti se. Nahi, ye bhi kahani hai ek. Maybe I'll tell you the story. I thought I'd not included this slide. But I'll tell you the story. The story is very interesting. Again, I don't know how much of it is true, but I'd done an article for HuffPost on this. You'll find the article also. Kahani ye hai, ki kai baar aapka sabse, aapka main differentiator of your product is not even in the product. It's outside of the product. Tequila. Now it's a good quality liqueur that's available, but if you ask the connoisseurs, the people who understand liqueurs well, they'll tell you that tequila is an inferior quality liqueur. It's not the most superior quality liqueur. Aapne piye, kitne logo ne tequila peeke dekhi hai? Bata do, teacher samne baithe, koi baat nahi. Ek hi bande ne piye, koi baat nahi. Itna sa shot hota hai. Kaise peete hai? Namak. हाँ, कभी ब्रिम पे लगा होता है, कभी हाथ पे रखते हैं और चाट लेते हैं, फिर शॉट लेते हैं, साथ में होता है नींबू, नींबू का वेज, और वो जल्दी से चूस लेते हैं. क्यों? इसकी भी एक बड़ी इंटरेस्टिंग कहानी. कहानी ये है कि मार्केट से डेटा आ गया था, मार्केट रिसर्च का डेटा. डेटा थोड़ा सा डैमिंग था. ये था कि भैया, पीपल आर नॉट कंज्यूमिंग टेकीला इनफ. व्हाई? बिकॉज टेकीला टेस्ट्स बैड. There were two problems with tequila. One, it wasn't smooth in its taste. And it has a very harsh aftertaste. Jaise aftertaste hota hai na, ek aftertaste. Peene ke baad jo aata hai, ghanda sa. To kehte hai, iske karan log kehte hai wo nahi. Aur dusra problem ye thi, ki usko meethi cheez ke saath khao to bahut hi ghanda taste aata hai. To ye data aaya tha. And then the marketing department was telling R&D department, you need to do something about the product. If you don't do anything about the product, the taste is not selling. Then someone came up with this idea. We don't know who. Ye kahin likha hua nahi hai. He said tequila cruda. Uska matlab tha, let's create a ritual. Usko unhone kaha tequila cruda. Ritual kya hoga? Let people take tequila in small shots, not in big glasses. Chota. Plus, keep the salt in your hand. Keep the shot ready. And keep the lime wedge. So you, when you lick salt, your mouth is nothing but salty. You can't be sweet, right? Salt. And then after you've taken that shot, there is a lime wedge which is there to rescue you when that bad aftertaste hits you. Logon ko wo ritually pasand aa gaya. Matlab ek ke baad ek repeat kare ja rahe hain. Another, repeat, repeat. Akele nahi, group, 100 ke 100. What is getting consumed? Tequila. Tequila with the same bad aftertaste. But people are ready to go that distance and make sure there's salt when they are having it, to make sure there's lime. Someone actually criticized this idea, said, if you do that, our product becomes a niche product. What if they don't have salt? What if they don't have lemon? Our tequila doesn't get consumed. Kya baat kya kar rahe ho yaar? Tum hum kaise control kar sakte hain? Consumer kahan hai, kya kha raha hai, kya pee raha hai? So, but people love the ritual. Because they love the ritual, Pikila kept saying. Now this is what we call meme, right? Memes khali internet meme nahi hoti. Aisi memes bhi hoti hain jo phailti hain. Ab kisi ko advertise karne ki zarurat nahi hai tequila. They are like memes, they spread virally. And you know that market has accepted your meme when market becomes your brand manager. You don't need a brand manager. Because market then iterates on your own meme and invents new ones. Ab dekho, people started with this meme that have put salt on your hand, have tequila, have lemon. But after people said, why should the salt be on my hand? Why can't it be on her hand? They said, that'll be very interesting if that happens. So that began to happen. See, that is a variation people brought in, not the tequila company. And then someone said, why should it be on her hand? You know, amazing stuff happened. Then body shots happened. There's something called body shot. So this is how memes grow. And that's how products become successful. Sometimes you create a new ritual, a new meme. Then you don't even have to advertise. So innovation could lie outside of a product often. All right. I think I'll need to now hurry up. I've done too much talking anyway. I'll just skip this. This is about ecosystems and blockchains. I thought I'll do it, but it's just too much of detail. I'll forget it. All right. I'll just end with these two slides. You know, there was a mountaineer who was asked about how he selects this is a mountaineer called Todd Skinner, who's scaled the tallest peak in each continent. So someone asked him, how do you choose your next target, your goal? So this is what he said. He said, if you are not afraid, you have probably chosen too easy a mountain. To be worth the expedition, it had better be intimidating. Imagine, it had better be intimidating. अगर आप पहाड़ के नीचे खड़े हुए आप चोटी को देख रहे हो, अगर आपको डर नहीं लग रहा तो वो लेने लायक नहीं है, चढ़ने लायक नहीं है, डर लगना चाहिए. एक तो ये. If you don't stand at the base uncertain how to reach the summit, then you have wasted the effort to get there. A mountain well within your ability is not only a misspending of resources, it's a loss of opportunity across a lifetime of potential achievement. Imagine, that's how people look at new targets. And look at today's managers in the corporate world. How do they do it? This is what they do. This is what they'll say. If you are afraid, you've probably chosen an impractical mountain. To be worth the expedition, it had better be realistic. If you stand at the base uncertain how to reach the summit, then you are wasting your time. Committing to climb a mountain well within your ability and making it sound like a great achievement is the hallmark of a great manager. Now this is how managers work, and this is how entrepreneurs work. The choice is yours. You could be an entrepreneur in your own company. You could be an entrepreneur in someone else's company. Don't be a manager. Be an entrepreneur, wherever you are. That's where I'll end. Thank you so much. I'll take questions if there are any. ये भी ले लीजिए. ये वैसे मैं ही रख देता हूँ. हाथ खड़ा कीजिए तो आपको माइक्रोफोन मिलेगा.
गुड आफ्टरनून सर.
नमस्कार
सर. हाउ टू टैकल judgmental minds, because being an innovator is something as a challenge to the person only. Because now also, if I was raising my hand after asking your question, who have actually taken the tequila shot, right?
Sorry, tequila shot, huh?
Yeah, you were saying na, who have actually taken the tequila shot, and I was the one who was raising my hand,
right?
So everyone started to judge, ये बिगड़ा हुआ है, इसने सब कुछ करा हुआ है, अपनी लाइफ इसने ऐसे कर रखी है, राइट?
बिल्कुल.
दिस इज द मेंटालिटी, एंड वी पीपल वी कांट लिव विद दिस मेंटालिटी ऑफ अदर्स एम्फसाइजिंग ऑन आवर सेल्फ.
आप मुझे बताओ, आपने कैसे अज्यूम कर लिया कि उन्होंने सोचा बिगड़ा हुआ है? वो कह रहे हैं वाह बड़ा कैसा हुआ है यार, हमने क्यों नहीं किया अभी तक, ऐसा भी सोच रहे हो सकते हैं। ये तो आपने सोच लिया, आपने खुद को जज किया। देखो सबसे बड़ा जज जो है ना, जिससे डील करना होता है वो खुद होता है, लोग नहीं होते इतने जज, वो कर भी क्या लेंगे जज करके। तो मैंने तो यही देखा है, जब भी किसी इंडस्ट्री में जाता हूँ, नया प्रोजेक्ट लेता हूँ, जज करने वाले तो बड़े बैठे हैं, वो उनकी प्रॉब्लम है, वो मेरी थोड़ी है। मुझे तो उसको टैकल करना है जो मेरी अपनी जजमेंट अपने आप पे हो रही है कि तू नहीं कर पाएगा। सबसे बड़ा एनिमी तो वो है, नई सोच का, लोग नहीं है। लोग कितना सोच के भी कर क्या लेंगे यार, आपकी रूह थोड़ी ले जाएंगे।
अप्रिशिएट दैट, थैंक यू वेरी मच सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
नमस्कार
सर। हमारे पास जब भी कोई आइडिया होता है तो हमारे पास उसके साथ एक प्रॉब्लम आती है, वो होती है इन्वेस्टमेंट की। तो हम उसमें सोचते हैं कि यार इन्वेस्टमेंट कहाँ से आएगा, घर से कहेंगे कि इतना पैसा दे दो तो घर वाले कहेंगे पहले पढ़ लो, पढ़ाई पूरी करो। तो सर उसे हम सोल्व कैसे करते हैं? कभी हम सोचते हैं कि चलो हम कोई कुछ चीज़ कर रहे हैं तो उसके लिए हम इन्वेस्टमेंट कहाँ से लाएंगे, कि हाँ हमारे यहाँ इंडियन गवर्नमेंट कुछ प्रोग्राम करवाएंगे, वहाँ जाएंगे, वहाँ से कुछ मिलेगा, तो वो प्रॉब्लम कैसे सोल्व हो सकती है सर?
सी, वो जो हमारा माइंडसेट है ना, वो बड़ा स्लेव माइंडसेट है, वो बड़ा कॉलोनियल माइंडसेट है, वो बड़ा अधीन रहने का आदि है। वो सोचता है कोई हमें देगा तो हम करेंगे। आप सोचो, अगर हमने एयरबीएनबी का एग्जांपल लिया या उबर का एग्जांपल लिया, कोई उस टाइम उनको, वो लोग जाके लोगों को ये कह रहे थे, जहां दुनिया कह रही थी जितना गुड़ डालोगे उतना मीठा होगा, वो कह रहे थे आधे गुड़ में डबल मीठा करेंगे। लोग हंसते थे उन पर, उन्होंने आधे गुड़ से डबल मीठा कर दिया। तो हो सकता है, लेकिन अगर आप पुराने आइडियाज को, पुराने मेथड्स को यूज कर रहे हैं, आप पुराना खेल खेल रहे हैं। इफ यू नॉट अ गेम चेंजर, इफ यू प्लेइंग द ओल्ड गेम एंड इफ यू हैव टू बीट द ओल्डर चैंपियंस हु आर ऑलरेडी चैंपियंस, देन यू हैव टू आउटडू देम इन इन्वेस्टमेंट इन एवरीथिंग एल्स। बट इफ यू आर इंट्रोड्यूसिंग अ न्यू गेम, देन इट्स योर ओन गेम, देन यू डोंट नीड टू। समटाइम्स जीरो पैसे में आप बदल सकते हो, बट इफ द आइडिया इज सो ग्रेट एंड यू कैन फाइंड इवन few champions outside, they'll be ready to put money on it. That's why VCs are there, right? पहले तो बैंक देता था, ये था, वो था, अब तो VCs आके ऐसे दे देते हैं ना। वो VC आपकी एक्सेल शीट देख के नहीं देते खाली, वो आपकी वो दे सी द ग्लिंट इन योर आई एंड द कन्विक्शन इन योर आई, वो पैसा निकाल के आपको पकड़ा देते हैं, दे प्लेस अ बेट ऑन यू। तो आजकल पैसे कॉन्सेप्ट पे नहीं दिए जाते, चैंपियंस पे दिए जाते।
थैंक यू सर। और सर एक क्वेश्चन हो रहा है कि हमने ये कहा कि अगर आजकल जो मार्केटिंग चल रही है उसमें है कि अगर हमारी मार्केटिंग अच्छी है, ठीक है, तो हम सक्सेस होंगे, चाहे हमारा मटेरियल कैसा ही है, अगर हमारी मार्केटिंग अच्छी है। उसका एक अच्छा एग्जांपल चाइना है, वहाँ की कंपनी अपनी मार्केटिंग पे फोकस करती है। लेकिन इंडिया में जो इस समय मोबाइल्स फ़ोन्स वगैरह है, उसके दो एग्जांपल है ओप्पो और वीवो, उनकी मार्केटिंग पिछले दो साल में सबसे अच्छी रही है, लेकिन उनका मार्केट शेयर बहुत कम हुआ है, वो ऐसा क्यों है?
देखो मार्केटिंग अच्छी हो, अच्छी का मतलब क्या, अच्छी का मतलब ये हो सकता है कि आई एम
एक्टिव,
नहीं तो लेट्स ट्राई एंड आंसर दिस। इट कुड बी ईदर यू आर आउट शाउटिंग द कॉम्पिटिशन, विच मीन्स अगर कॉम्पिटिशन 30 करोड़ खर्च रहा है, मैं 40 खर्चूंगा, मैं ज्यादा जगहों में आऊंगा, और आई एम आउट स्मार्टिंग द कॉम्पिटिशन, विच मीन्स मैं ऐसी चीज कहता हूं कि मुझे एडवर्टाइजिंग स्पेस खरीदनी नहीं पड़ती, वो वायरल हो जाता है। ठीक है, आई कैन आउट स्मार्ट देम, इधर आउट शाउट देम और आई कैन आउट स्मार्ट देम, ये दो चीजें हैं मार्केटिंग में। दूसरा ये है, ये मानना कि मार्केटिंग की भी जरूरत है। अगर आप देखो शुरुआत में एप्पल ने कभी मार्केट नहीं किया था, गूगल कितना मार्केट करता है, आपने एड्स देखी है गूगल की? तो कई बार अगर आपने प्रोडक्ट इतना अनोखा बनाया है तो लोग आपके पास आएंगे, पीपल विल सी द इनेट पावर ऑफ इट, and things that have such innate power don't need marketing at all.
Thank you sir.
Anyone else? Come on.
Sir, government had provided 10,000 crores for new startup, but sir मैं 6 महीने से घूम रहा हूँ अपनी ब्लूप्रिंट लेके, पर अभी तक उनकी फाइल कुछ आगे नहीं बढ़ रही है मेरी, तो मतलब क्या करूँ? मतलब
दूसरे जरिए अपनाओ, जरूरी थोड़ी अब सरकार की जब तक वेट करते रहोगे तो करते रहोगे, जरिए बहुत
सर, पर
होते हैं।
मेरा आइडिया ऐसा है कि मतलब जब तक वो मार्केट में पता नहीं चलेगा, जब तक मैं कुछ नहीं कर
लेकिन
पाऊंगा।
नहीं सरकार आपको सरकार इज जस्ट वन वे ऑफ फंडिंग द आइडिया, राइट? अगर सरकार कह रही है स्टैंड अप इंडिया, स्टार्टअप इंडिया, आप एंजल इन्वेस्टर से मिलो। एंजल कौन होते हैं? मैंने भी इन्वेस्ट कर रखा है कई चीजों में। एंजल सबसे मे बी आई आई डोंट नो इफ यू नो दैट फर्स्ट कम्स योर ओन, यू बूटस्ट्रैप योर आइडिया, व्हिच मींस अपनी सेविंग्स में से। दूसरा है आप एंजल इन्वेस्टर्स के पास जाते हो, वो कौन होते हैं?
इंस्टीट्यूट, फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूट।
नहीं, सुनिए, एंजल इन्वेस्टर्स होते हैं, उनको कहते हैं 3 F's, फैमिली फ्रेंड्स फूल्स। ये होते हैं एंजल इन्वेस्टर्स। या तो आपकी फैमिली ऐसे डाल देगी, भाई इसका आइडिया आइडिया था, समझ ना आ रहा, लेकिन कह रहा है पप्पू तो दे दो, तो वो फैमिली हो गई। फ्रेंड कहता है यार दोस्त अपना ही है यार, डाल देते हैं 2 लाख रुपए, या लाख रुपया डाल देते हैं, बाइक खरीदनी थी चलते रहे वेंचर में, डाल दिया दोस्त, फैमिली फ्रेंड्स। और फूल्स वो होते हैं जिसको आइडिया गट में पसंद आ जाता है, वो कुछ नहीं देखना चाहते कि वो कैसा है, डाल दिया पैसा, ऐसे भी डालते हैं। मैं फूल रहा हूँ कईयों के साथ, मैंने डाला है क्योंकि मुझे लग रहा है ये बंदा ठीक है यार, इसको देना है। तो पहले तो सबसे पहले बूटस्ट्रैपिंग, देन एंजल इन्वेस्टर्स, देन VCs, वेंचर कैपिटलिस्ट, उसके बाद प्राइवेट इक्विटी, और उससे पहले भी प्राइवेट इक्विटी भी आता है, उसके बाद बड़े इन्वेस्टर्स आते हैं। तो आप देखो आइडिया को, अब एक और चीज़ है, पहले ये होता था कि आपने ब्लूप्रिंट बनाया और आपने कहा इस आइडिया को सक्सेसफुल करने के लिए मुझे 2 करोड़ रुपए चाहिए। लेट्स टेक अ मेटाफर, अगर आपको पहले पूरा महल बनाना है कोई, तो आप कहोगे पहले उसका मैं पहले उसकी खुदाई करूं, फिर मैं उसमें फाउंडेशन डालूं, फिर धीरे धीरे होगा, और फिर साथ के साथ सारे उसमें, अगर महल में 100 कमरे हैं तो साथ के साथ एक बार महल बन जाएगा। लेकिन अगर मैं आपको कहूं सबसे पहला एक कमरा बनाने में कितने पैसे लगेंगे, क्योंकि आपके 10 करोड़ तो लगेंगे महल बनाने में, लेकिन अगर एक कमरा बनाना हो जो सारी फंक्शनैलिटी हो उस महल की, उस कमरे में, एक कमरे में, तो कितना पैसा लगेगा? आप कहोगे वो तो 20 लाख में हो जाएगा, तो आपको 20 लाख ही चाहिए। 20 लाख लो, एक कमरा बनाओ, उसमें रहना शुरू कर दो, दुनिया देखेगी क्या मजेदार है, दुनिया आएगी पैसे लेके कि भैया इसमें तो हम भी रहना चाहते हैं, ऐसे कमरे हमें भी चाहिए, सब लोग 2-2 लाख रुपए दे जाएंगे, आपके पास पैसे इकट्ठे हो गए। तो इसको कहते हैं, दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इन स्टार्टअप्स इज कॉल्ड MVP, मिनिमम वायबल प्रोडक्ट। व्हाट इज योर मिनिमम वायबल प्रोडक्ट? अगर मैंने कार बनानी है तो बड़ी कंपनी को बोलेगी कि भैया एक कार को ब्लूप्रिंट से सड़क तक लाने के लिए 7 साल चाहिए। पहले हम कार की मेन ड्राइंग्स बनेंगी, प्लेटफॉर्म बनेगा, चेसी बनेगी, सब सिस्टम्स बनेंगे, फिर कार। और अगर कोई मैनेजमेंट कहती है कि आप पहला प्रोटोटाइप कब दिखाओगे मुझे, तो टीम कहेगी 7 साल में तो रोड पे आएगी, 5 साल में आपको दिखा देंगे प्रोटोटाइप। लेकिन स्टार्टअप वाले लोग क्या कहेंगे? 100 डेज, MVP इन 100 डेज, क्योंकि 100 दिन में वो जो बड़ी कंपनी ने किया होगा वो खाली ड्राइंग बन के प्लेटफॉर्म बन रहा होगा। ये कहेंगे कार का मतलब क्या है? समथिंग दैट टेक्स यू फ्रॉम ए टू बी। हाउ कैन वी प्रूव दैट आर आइडिया इज वायबल? एक प्लेटफॉर्म विद 4 व्हील्स विद अ मोटर हम कितने दिनों में खड़ा कर सकते हैं दिखाने के लिए कि ये काम करेगी? 100 दिन में। और उसके लिए कितना पैसा चाहिए? उसके लिए 2 करोड़ नहीं चाहिए, उसके लिए खाली 1 लाख रुपया चाहिए। दैट्स हाउ इट वर्क्स।
बट सर, मैंने अपना आइडिया गुड़गांव के कंपनी है JMD मॉल में, तो मैंने उनके साथ अपना आइडिया शेयर करा, तो ही विल प्रोवाइडेड 6 लाख एट अ टाइम, बट वो बोल रहे थे कि आप अपना सेल आउट कर दो। मैंने एट अ टाइम मना कर दिया, क्योंकि सर मुझे उस आइडिया को अपना आगे वर्कआउट करना है। बट
दोज आर चॉइसिस यू विल मेक, बट आई एम सेइंग दैट। और ये भी होगा कि आप बहुत लोगों से पूछोगे, वो आपको फंडिंग नहीं देंगे।
हाँ
वो भी आपकी सीख है कि मैं हाउ कैन आई मेक बिगर चैंपियंस ऑफ माई आइडिया आउटसाइड, हाउ कैन आई गो एंड पिच माई आइडिया। ये भी एक बड़ा आर्ट है ना, हाउ डू यू पिच योर आइडिया? पॉसिबिलिटीज, इट्स नॉट दैट आइडिया इज बैड, मे बी आई एम नॉट पिचिंग राइट, और मे बी आई एम नॉट पिचिंग टू द राइट काइंड ऑफ पीपल।
बट सर, मेरा जो आइडिया वो स्टार्ट करने में ही मैक्स टू मैक्स 50 टू 60 लैक्स लगने ही है। just because of advertisement and through website. That's the main reason ki advertisement.
वो आपकी सोच है, आपकी सोच है. अगर आपकी सोच है 50 लाख लगने हैं, तो आप ढूंढो कौन आपको दे सकता है 50 लाख. Maybe you haven't found the right kind of people yet, or maybe you haven't pitched properly. Maybe there is another person. जैसे आपने आइडिया सोच के बैठे, आजकल अगर कोई भी आइडिया हम सोचते हैं, हमें पता है 100 और लोग दुनिया भर में इस आइडिया के साथ एक्सपेरिमेंट अभी कर रहे होंगे अपने अपने गैराज में बैठ के. हो सकता है कोई और आइडिया, कोई और बंदा आएगा लेके और वो कहेगा यही आइडिया, ये भाई साहब कह रहे हैं 50 लाख चाहिए, मैं ये 10 लाख में प्रूव कर सकता हूं. वो उसकी सोच है. तो हम ये कह रहे हैं ये खेल तो सोच का है ना. आप उस अगर ऐसे बैठे रहेंगे देन वी विल ओनली सिट विद ग्रजेस कि दुनिया बड़ी अनफेयर है. वो जमाने तो चले गए कि एक्सटर्नलाइज करें, सब इंटरनलाइज करो. नहीं हुआ हमसे नहीं हुआ, नहीं बेच पाए हम नहीं बेच पाए. ये नहीं कि दुनिया खराब थी खरीदा नहीं. अगर फंडिंग नहीं आई हम नहीं ला पाए. ये नहीं कि वो उन्होंने नहीं दिया, वो बड़े खराब हैं, वो कह रहे हैं बेच दो. वो तो वो है, हम क्या हो सकते हैं. वो इनोवेशन तो वहां होती है.
थैंक यू सर.
सर जस्ट द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम माय एंड टू. While observing and being attentive in your session, I wanted to ask you that between idea and opportunity, which term do you feel holds gravity more, to present an idea or to present an opportunity when I go in for innovation with my organization or with my startup plan? So should I present it as an idea or an opportunity to the people, to the investors?
Okay, opportunity is an interesting term. It could mean different things to different people. Opportunity, the way you define it, could be an opportunity for the consumers, it could be opportunity for you, or it could be opportunity for the investors. Or it could be an opportunity area that is waiting to be leveraged outside in the market, right? So the most compelling way is to show, to first highlight the opportunity area. A lot of times, we choose the same old opportunity areas, but try and find new ideas. Right, but if you can spot a new opportunity area, that's the most compelling thing. People say, wow, no one thought of that, no one's seen that before. Now that excites most people far more. Opportunity area, and therefore what is my idea that will help me leverage that opportunity. Idea is just a vehicle, it's a means to leveraging the opportunity. So the main hero is opportunity, and people place their bets, like I said, on there are three things: concept, champion, कॉन्टेक्स्ट. सो आप लेके तो कॉन्सेप्ट जाते हो, वो पैसे जो डालने वाले हैं वीसीज हैं वो चैंपियन पे डालते हैं. ये कॉन्सेप्ट है इस कॉन्टेक्स्ट में, मतलब इस अपॉर्चुनिटी. मैं ये वाला कॉन्सेप्ट लेके आया हूं और ये उत्तराखंड के लिए है, और या यही कॉन्सेप्ट है मैं केरला में भी ले जाऊंगा. वो कहेंगे नहीं केरला पे तो नहीं चलेगा, बिकॉज केरला एज अ कॉन्टेक्स्ट इज अ वेरी डिसेबलिंग कॉन्टेक्स्ट फॉर दिस काइंड ऑफ अ कॉन्सेप्ट.